Saturday morning. Welcome to Sports Talk. And we've got seem to have things up and running now.
Correctly. Take two, right?
Take two, exactly. Yeah. Hey. And that, even on live.
Yeah.
Even on live radio or internet stream, you can have two takes. But glad to have you with us here on a wet and soggy Saturday morning, as I was saying, but only the guys in here with me this morning heard. Great day to stay inside, sit in a chair, lay in a bed, whatever it may be, and listen to Sports Talk as we get you set for another Saturday of college football and another Sunday of NFL football. But high school football, how about this? You know, it's been the wackiest year, hadn't it?
Yes,
I mean,
sir.
You know, we're through 6 weeks, and I think 4 weeks have been affected by weather. Whether it's lightning delays at games, some of those games even at lightning so long, they moved them till, you know, 3 days later to play on Monday. 4 weekends out of six. When's our good weather coming for high school football Friday nights?
October.
Hopefully we got some.
Coming up
That's
here in
what
October.
I'm saying. I mean, you look at extended forecast, I think rain's
I was about to
going
say,
into next week.
I hope in the playoffs.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm taking pictures. I don't want no rain.
And the trips will be longer.
You know what we did to fix that right there?
Pushed a button?
Nothing. He says he didn't push anything.
That's scary.
I walked down the hall and walked
that ghost,
back.
That ghost you talked about.
And everything started working.
That's right.
I was talking about that ghost earlier. And
there
he
you go.
Hit the off button.
There you go.
He's come, silenced us.
The ghost is coming into play.
I officially
already.
Believe 100% that there is a ghost.
we got a seat for him right there.
Yeah.
If he wants it. So if you see that chair move, though, I might be out of here.
Yeah, me too.
I'll make a new door. And I'm sure Jason will be first.
Oh, God. Jason
will be out of here in a heartbeat. But plenty of high school football over the last couple nights that we're going to cover this morning and talk with you about. Also, baseball's winding down. Next weekend's last weekend, right? Last weekend regular season,
I think,
Major League Baseball. So
congrats,
a lot of stuff
Terry.
Starting to shape up. A lot of stuff starting to shape up. Yeah, yeah. Division champ.
Yeah, first time in, since 85.
85. Well, guess what we did in 1985?
Well, you won the World Series.
Okay.
Y'all cheated to win World
We didn't win. Cheat. Your dad was showing me a replay of some calls that were made in that series.
In St. Louis' favor. He ought to be ashamed.
Well, I told him, I said, he was safe. And your dad kept saying, look, he got him by about a whole step. And I said, what'd that ref call?
He was still in the batter's box when the first baseman caught that ball.
Oh, man. Well, we're really going back. We're going way back. Kevin, were you born then?
I was three.
Three? Okay.
You know the funniest thing about it, though? St. Louis with the best record and have not wrapped up that division because Pittsburgh keeps winning.
It's been a great race,
yeah,
hasn't it?
It's aggravating. They need to quit this crap. I mean, really. I mean, come on. Just take it. You got the wild card. Well, the problem is the Cubs are right behind them.
And the Cubs also have an ace pitcher.
Maybe probably rested some pitchers or some other stuff down the stretch a little bit, too.
Arrieta or whatever his name is.
Arrieta,
who wants to go into that game and have to face him in a one game?
And congratulations to Chicago. They're in.
Cubs made it. Cubs clinched.
Okay. The Giants were eliminated last night.
I'm happy the Cubs made it, though, because we all know they're not going to win it. So that eliminates one team that the Cardinals have to worry about.
Well, I've been saying for years, back to the future, maybe on to something.
Yeah.
Now, if that happens, y'all, I quit.
Yeah.
I'm done with life.
Hey, Kevin.
I'm doing a cult.
Never counted out. I was a Red Sox fan. You know, I am a Red Sox fan, and I thought
you know
for years.
You know what he's talking about?
I thought for years we'd never see one.
Yeah.
It's 2015.
You know what he's talking about? Back to the Future, David?
Which part?
Back to the Future Part 2.
Yeah, it predicted that this year the Cubs would.
Oh, really?
Series.
Yes.
Yes.
Mm.
The day Marty McFly traveled into 2015, it was it's coming up, too. Hold on.
Wouldn't that be something if they picked the year?
Now, what it did pick them, it also picked them to beat the Miami team. And there was no Miami team then.
No, yeah.
I know they can't play the Miami
team.
Well,
that's off. And Miami is pretty bad.
Who's director of that movie?
Was that Steven Spielberg?
Well, you know what's going to happen. Whoever they beat. In the World Series is going to move to Miami next year.
I guess the aliens forgot to tell Spielberg that the Marlins were going to be in the East.
But he traveled in the future October 21st, 2015. So that's the day Marty McFly traveled in the 2015 where it showed the Cubs won the World Series.
What was the movie that when the Red Sox, the year they won their first one in 80 or 90 years, whatever it was, they had to go back and change the end of the movie because
Fever Pitch. Fever Pitch.
In the movie,
Fallon.
They didn't have them winning it, so they had to go back and change it.
I promise you I didn't watch that movie. I wasn't watching a love story how Major League Baseball fixed the World Series for y'all to win it.
I want to send you video clips all day long the rest of the day of Fever Pitch.
Ugh, I threw up.
College football. Who won the Oregon State game last night? Stanford and Oregon State played late last night.
Man, I hope Stanford lost.
I'm asking, I fell asleep.
I hope
Stanford
lost.
They took y'all out of the national title.
No, right? Not necessarily, because you can lose one game early in the season at home. Just look at Ohio State last year.
Well, Alabama still thinks they're number one.
So, still in there, man. We still in there.
Still in there. You know, we'll see some one-loss teams
can
get in.
Can NC State lose one game and go to the national championship, Terry?
No. Alabama, USC, y'all are out.
That's what
you hope.
That's what's got him fired up some more.
Well, that's why I really quit. I'm disgusted with college football, and I quit watching a long time ago for a lot of part. Is because of that reason. Carolina and NC State, Duke, these guys have to go undefeated and then probably have to make a case. Florida State had to make a case almost being an ACC champion.
Yeah.
And, you know, what would NC State or North Carolina have to do if they won it?
Well, it's all about how they put so much emphasis on preseason rankings. Yeah, you shouldn't have rankings there. Yeah,
that kills me.
But Boise State, Boise State beat Virginia last night 56-14, but Stanford did defeat
Oregon.
That was
Oregon.
Unbelievable. Yeah. Stanford did defeat Oregon game, State 42-24, and they covered the spread. Spread was 14. They won by 18.
There you go. So Virginia pounded at home
last
night by Boise State, and a lot of that I heard on the way home. I was just hearing a few things about special teams touchdowns and defensive touchdowns, things like that. I think they had two pick sixes and either in the first half or maybe within the first series of the second
fumble
half.
Fumble return for a touchdown.
Really?
Yeah.
My gosh.
I think Mike London's on the hot seat and is probably going to be leaving Virginia.
So. How many years has he been there? He's third?
No. This is a little bit longer because he was at Richmond doing apps run. Yeah. I want to say it's probably about his fifth or sixth season.
Okay.
Yeah. I think he's a good coach.
Yeah. I mean,
that's just me. I think he's a good coach. I think he has his team prepared most of the times for who they're playing. I mean, you know, but.
Yeah, I agree with you.
I just don't think you got all the talent up there at Virginia.
What they always say, no matter what the sport, you know, before you get rid of somebody, look at the choices of who you're going to get that's better. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. Who are you going to get that's better? Just run down a little bit real quick, and then we're going to get into high school football this morning as well. But LSU and Syracuse, LSU looked pretty stout, guys, last Saturday with Leonard Fournette, who might be the best player in college football at running back, leading the way for him in that win over Auburn. Did not make Auburn look like an SEC team.
No. And Leonard Fournette definitely the leader, the front runner for the Heisman Trophy already.
Yes, he is.
Auburn, it was such bad. They switched quarterbacks this week.
They sure did. They sure did. I'm not sure that he's been missing tackles.
No.
On defense.
And there was a couple of Auburn players that made business decisions that were like, nah, I'm not about to try to even tackle Mr. Fournette.
Just a few more top 25. That LSU-Syracuse game is in New York at noon. That's an early start. Rice is at Baylor. That one's at 3 o'clock today. Baylor's number 5 in the country. Oklahoma State, who's ranked 24th, goes to Texas. How many points can Oklahoma State score on Texas?
Say it put up at least 40.
That's right.
Scary, 42.
Well, they'll have a new coach next year when Kelly leaves Philadelphia and goes to Texas.
They fired the AD, Steve Patterson. Remember we talked about Steve Patterson? He got fired. But him and Charlie, haven't named one yet. Him and Charlie, he hired Charlie Strong, but Charlie Strong and him wasn't getting, you know, they weren't like, oh, that was Charlie Strong's guy. And the reason being, as soon as he hired Charlie Strong and as soon as he hired Shaka Smart, you know what he did? He cut their budgets in half. So Texas is an athletic program that made almost $100 million last year.
They should have the highest budget.
Cut the football coaches' staff, like their graduate assistants and their – and their quality control, basically the entry level to get into college coaching, they were being paid less than what they were paying at Kansas. And then for Shaka Smart at Texas, once he come there, restricted the use he can use the Texas jet as far as recruiting, cut down the number of hours he can go out as far as using the jet to fly and see kids across the country.
So in the future, when you get hired as a head coach, make sure that's part of the contract,
yeah,
that the budget is not going to be cut over the next few years, because even though you're getting your money, it's gonna cut down on your wins.
And then raise season ticket prices after they went 6-7 last year.
Ooh.
On full football.
Sound like the NFL. UMass at Notre Dame today at 3 o'clock. Notre Dame somehow finding ways to win. They continue to win even without probably six starters or so that they started the season with.
But I think that's all credit to Brian Kelly. He's doing a great job at Notre Dame. It's kind of remember 2 or 3 years ago when Notre Dame made the national championship. I think that was good coaching by Brian Kelly. That's the reason they got there. So
they were actually blowing Georgia Tech out last week to the last two. I think Georgia Tech, in like 15 seconds apart, scored two touchdowns there near the end of the game to get within eight. So Ohio State, number one. They struggled a little bit last week, guys, but they did win the game. So that's a sign of good teams. Not don't play well, but still win. They play Western Michigan today. They better not struggle in that
one. Well, you know, they struggled in Northern Illinois, and they started with Cardale Jones, and then they brought in JT Barrett. He was somewhat better, but not much better. That Cardale Jones is remaining the starter this seat for this week.
Yeah, you guys think that's going to hurt them in the long run? They could keep switching back and forth.
He's going to have to make a decision. Just stick with it. Yeah, he's going to have eventually. You can't have that. You know, is he going to be my quarterback? Is he not? If he messes up,
if you go out there and don't play well one game, you know, chances are you're going to play well the next game.
Yeah, right? Ever past a quarterback makes, he's like, okay, am I going to get yanked now?
Yeah,
you can't
looking over the shoulder the entire time. I agree. Number 12, Alabama, is at home against Louisiana Monroe.
Maybe they can win today.
They probably will roll Tide in that one. That's a 4 o'clock game. 4:45 today. What was you going to say?
I was going to think about Ole Miss, all the things that went right for Ole Miss last week.
They beat Alabama two straight years.
Two straight years.
Not many teams do that.
Alabama, it's been a long time. Yep. In the early 1900s, maybe, since the first time they beat at Alabama. But think about it. They had that one where the quarterback drops the snap. You know, snap goes over, picks it up, and just flings it up. It's tipped off a defender into the receiver's hand for Ole Miss, and then he takes it to the house.
But I'm going to be honest with you. That game was not as close as what it should have been, because I think Alabama scored them last couple of touchdowns to make it close.
It
should not have been that close.
Oh, okay.
And then who knows what the drama is going to be on the sideline today with Lane Kiffin making the news. Let's just say there's been some rumors that he's been fraternizing not only with some boosters' wives, but with Nick Saban's daughter.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, so let's see what
Have you seen Lane Kiffin's wife?
Yeah.
Why is he? Yeah.
But have you seen Nick Saban's daughter?
Well, you might have me there. You might have me there. I can't remember. I think I have, but it's been a while. So, I guess you went up on me there, Jason. I can't come back with that one. 4:45 today. Number 3 TCU takes on Texas Tech. Both teams 3-0 in this game, and Texas Tech playing at home. That's probably one of your more entertaining games, and that one's on Fox today at 4:45.
Where is TCU ranked at right now?
They're number three.
Number 3. Okay.
Yeah, and TCU, they haven't shown. Boykin hasn't been as strong in Texas Tech. Texas Tech is looking pretty good. I mean, got to beat Arkansas, and Arkansas, Coach Bielma needs to learn to keep his mouth shut, because he was talking crap about Texas Tech, and that kind of backfired. So, I mean, Texas Tech is a pretty solid football team, so TCU can't sleep on them.
And that is Clingsbury?
Yeah, Cliff Clingsbury. Yeah,
is the head coach there now? Arkansas is at home today to take on 14th ranked Texas A&M. How about 1-2 Arkansas now that we say, as you were just mentioning about. Vanderbilt is at Ole Miss. Ole Miss now moves up to number 3 in the country and number 1 poll as well. Play at home, try to stay undefeated. Will they have a letdown in this game? Because Vanderbilt's never a pushover. You know, I mean, they're always pretty good themselves.
Yeah, so. That trap game.
Even though it's at home for Ole Miss. Kentucky's at home to take on 3-0 Missouri. What an ugly game Missouri was involved in last week with UConn. But there again, they found a way to win. Here's another game matching ranked teams. Number 9 UCLA at number 16 Arizona tonight at 8 o'clock on ABC.
Both undefeated, and big showcase game as far as who's going to take the lead in that Pac-12 South.
And also good news for Arizona. I heard that Scooby Wright, the linebacker for Arizona, will be playing at tonight's game. That's going to be a big. That's good news for Arizona.
Yeah. A descendant of Scoop Dog or Scooby Doo?
I think it's for Scooby Doo.
Okay. Also, 8 o'clock tonight, Big Ten Network has Ball State at Northwestern. Northwestern undefeated still on the season. Hawaii is at Wisconsin tonight. Wisconsin's ranked number 22 in the country. 8:30 tonight on Fox, another not many games today featuring two ranked teams, but this one does. Number 18, Utah at number 13, Oregon. Can Utah play with Oregon?
Yeah,
I believe so.
I think they can, but, you know, everyone seems to sleep on Utah no matter what year it is. So Oregon's got to be careful about Utah. I mean, we saw Michigan. They kind of slept on Utah, and look what happened. So I always like Utah being kind of that underdog team that you just cannot sleep on no matter what year is.
Number 19, Southern Cows at Appalachian – oh, excuse me, Arizona State University, ASU. Yeah.
First road game of the season already for SC, and see how they bounce back from their first loss of the season last week to Stanford.
And Stanford a winner again last night, as we already told you. Number 21, Stanford, was a winner last night over Oregon State, 42-24 in that game. Just real quick here, I was going to try and find something for you guys. Terry, who's the Wolfpack got today?
Help me out. South Alabama.
USA?
At South Alabama.
University of South Alabama.
Yeah. You got to give State credit because they are going on the road. How many teams like a State, I know Duke wouldn't do it, would go to an opponent's field and play them? State went to Old Dominion last week. They're going to South Alabama this week. So, not many teams around
South
here.
South Alabama is not a bad program at all. No. I mean, that's a, no. That's somewhere that you really should be ready to play. When you, not that you shouldn't be ready every week, but you better be ready when you roll in there because there are going to be a ton of athletes in that game. And you know, there's a lot of athletes down there in Alabama, and this is the guys that basically don't get to go to Auburn or Alabama. So they should be tough. Charlotte's at home today against Florida Atlantic, just to let you know the schedule for Charlotte. Louisville's at home against Samford. Just trying to find some more ACC games. Jason, Carolina today. Do you know?
Don't know.
I know Virginia Tech's at East Carolina.
Yes.
Carolina's playing Delaware in an interesting game at Durham as Georgia Tech tries to recover and Duke tries to recover as both those teams will be going against each other.
And one I always look forward to, for some reason, I always look forward to this matchup in the SEC every year. It used to always be Apple Festival Day, but now it's a week later. Tennessee at Florida. Tennessee playing in the swamp today in Florida. And Florida, they've struggled, but they're unbeaten, right?
Yes, they are.
They've struggled a little bit, but they're 3-0. And Tennessee probably kicking themselves in the rear because they feel like they should be 3-0 after they dropped that loss 2 weeks ago to Oklahoma after leading in the game. 17 to nothing. Is that not unbelievable? All right, we're going to take a timeout here on Sports Talk. Thanks for tuning in this morning. We're glad to have you with us. David Kiever, Terry Reinhart, Jason Barber, Kevin Hastings, and Evan Lubbock on the board. We'll take a timeout back with high school football rundown when we come back.
Rates are low today. The time is right to improve your home. We have home improvement loans and we're lending right now. Join your neighbors and friends and people all over our local communities who are improving the quality of their lives by improving the quality of their homes. We're an equal housing lender. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings. I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country for a live-ready remote broadcast this Saturday, September 26th at Quality Landscaping Materials. It's their gigantic grand opening event at the brand new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. You'll find landscape materials, storage buildings, and garages, plus stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more, and register to win some great prizes, too. And Big O Country will be there broadcasting live from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have free hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there for the gigantic grand opening event at Quality Landscaping Materials. Now in the new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Come check it out right across from Tractor Supply. Call 704-862-0770 for more information or visit the website at QualityLandscapeMaterials.com.
I'm Lon Helton, inviting you to join me as I count down the week's top 30 with Brett Eldridge, who's about to hit the road with Thomas Rhett.
We both have like fun personalities, but he has like, we both have two different styles of humor, but they match so well, and that's why we get along, because, you know, I can kind of be out there and crazy and goofy, and he'll shoot back something really fast.
That's Brett Eldridge this week on Country Countdown USA.
Country Countdown USA with Lon Helton, Friday afternoons 1 to 4, right here at Big O Country, and online at KTCBroadcasting.com.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties. Brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WOHS, WCSL, and WLON. And by Crossroads Ford and Shelby, your hometown Ford dealer. The Cleveland County Arts Council presents the Uptown Art Walk on Thursday, October 1st at 5:30 p.m. And also on October 1st, the Arts Council presents their African American Music Trial Exhibits. It also begins at 5:30 p.m. For more information, call the Cleveland County Arts Council at 704-484-2787. And it's the Something Pumpkin Cooking Contest during Cotton Ginning Days, October 10th. Entry deadline is September 30th. Categories include a main dish, desserts, miscellaneous, and a youth category. For more information, call 704-922-2113. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper, Big O Country, WOHS 1390 AM. WCSL 1590 AM, and WLON 1050 AM, and by Crossroads Ford in Shelby. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com.
Heading to the big game? Planning to tailgate with all of your friends? Then order the big tailgate pack from North Star Seafood in Dallas. Let them do the cooking for you. For $29.95, you get chicken tenders, baby shrimp, french fries, hush puppies, slaw, tea, and condiments. Again, only $29.95. Carry out only, please. And now every Tuesday is Taco Tuesday at the North Star Seafood, featuring fish and shrimp tacos, along with all of your favorites. The North Star Seafood, 3150 Dallas High Shoals Road in Dallas. Open 11 to 9 Monday through Thursday, till 9:30 Friday and Saturday. Having trouble finding a car or truck at a price you can afford? Your troubles are over when you stop in at Bill Holland Automotive in Lincoln. At Bill Holland Automotive in Lincoln, they make buying a pre-owned vehicle easy. No credit, no money to put down? Bill Holland Automotive has the banks to get you approved. Come and see the selection today at Mill Holland Automotive, 423 West Main Street in Lincoln, or visit the website at millhollandautomotive.com for a complete list of inventory. Give them a call at 704-736-1000.
Welcome back to Sports Talk. Glad to have you with us here on a rainy, wet Saturday morning. And it's a Sports Talk show. I don't like to talk a lot about the weather, but guess what? The weather is affecting the sports.
Yes,
so obviously we talk about the weather a little bit, and there'll be a lot of college games across the state and across the country, but across the state as well. And they will be affected, it looks like, by rain today throughout the day. 30% chance here by 1 o'clock, 40 to 50% chance then the rest of the day, all the way into tomorrow morning. And it really don't look good here, as I, you know, and this is iPhone weather. But rain Sunday, rain Monday, rain Tuesday, thunderstorms Wednesday, back to regular rain Thursday. But maybe by Friday next week, the next day we see the sun, and at least that's a football day. It's Friday, and then maybe if this holds true, I won't take a picture of it now because it'll change. But I'd love to see the sunny weekend next weekend, because a lot of plans. I know a lot of people that are planning on attending college football games next week, like Jason and myself are. So there was, you know,
just wish it was sunny today for me, because you know it's my birthday today, and I
Jason,
yeah,
happy birthday. He's already mentioned that once. He's tried to get us to say something a while ago.
Y'all
were just about twins.
That's
what people say when they're listening,
because Jason might have been born at 11:59 p.m. and Smoke at 12:01 the next day.
Now, according to my mom and dad, it would be about 10:15 this morning. It would be.
Wouldn't that be a good trivia question? Wonder how many twins have different birthdays.
Well,
you'd be born at 11:59 and the next one at 12:01. It could happen.
That's pretty cool, honestly. That would be
cool. You could say we're twins but different birthdays, and nobody's going
to
believe you.
Speaking of birthdays, I need to say it while we're on there, because I won't be on there Monday probably. Monday is my nephew Liam's birthday. He'll turn in 5. Our party's tomorrow during the Cowboys and Panthers
Liam
Panthers
Neeson
events. Yeah. William Liam. We call him Liam. It's William. Dang it, I done forgot his name. Andrew William Lux of the Fourth. He's got four freaking names.
He's got a hyphen in there?
Yeah.
He's an athlete then.
But we're going to have a fun time then. And I also want to wish happy birthday to my grandmother a few days ago. She just turned 81 years young. She's kicking strong right up the street right up here. And she's just as feisty as ever. So happy birthday to her too. So big happy birthday weekend to everybody, yeah, I guess, in here.
You know, I read this somewhere that September, there's more birthdays, I think, in the United States.
New Year's.
Out of the 12. Glad Kevin wasn't on camera when he's shouting that out over there. But, yeah, fireworks, right, Kevin?
Yeah.
A lot of fireworks. So that's what he meant. A lot of fireworks on around New Year's. So.
Yeah, just a little bit.
There you have it. There you have it. Happy birthday, Jason.
Thanks.
And happy birthday to you, Smoke.
Thank you. Our
two guys right in here, our twins, are enjoying birthdays back to back. Big night last night. I know you got some scores you're probably going to report from Thursday as well. I think there was about eight games or so in our area from Thursday. Terry and Jason's got them all for you right now.
All right, in the Southern District, Southern District 7 2A Conference, East Lincoln played Bandies on Thursday night as they moved their win streak to 21 now, or 22? 21 games in a row, and they defeated Bandies 56-7. Maiden played on Thursday night as well. They defeated Bunker Hill 46-23. And the game that Smoke and I had last night up in Newton Conover is West Caldwell picking up the first conference win of the year as they defeated Newton Conover 42-30. And the smack is Shelby knocking off Kings Mountain in the Battle of Buffalo Creek 34-20. And Crest on RS Central will be made up on Monday.
Burns at East Burke will be made up on Monday at 7 p.m. Drawn at Chase will be made up on Monday at 7 p.m. In the Northern Piedmont 3A, 4A, North Lincoln scored all their points in one game. No, they did well. Smoke.
They did.
It was North Lincoln 70, North Iredale 49. I would hate to score 49 and lose. Got beat.
Lose period, but much less by three touchdowns.
Yes. It was Mooresville and Statesville will be played Monday at 7 p.m. And South Iredale goes to 4-1 on the year with a 54-27 win over Alexander Central.
It's Lake Norman moving to 4-1 on the season as they defeated West Iredale 36-6. In the Big South, it's Ashbrook shutting out Stuart Kramer 39-0. Games to be made up on Monday would be East Gaston at South Point, mm-hmm. Lake Norman Charter at Forest View, and Hunter Huss at North Gaston.
In the Southern Piedmont 1A, it was Highland Tech and Bessemer City. This game is Monday at 7 p.m. It was Community School of Davison going to 4-2 as they defeat Mountain Island Charter 57-0. Mountain Island Charter falls to 0-4 in the conference.
Wow.
It was Forbush 40, Cherryville 0, and Pine Lake Prep stays undefeated with a 32-20 win over Concord First Assembly.
And in the Northwestern 3A, 4A, it's Freedom moving to 4-1 on the season as they defeated Fred T. Ford 47-7. Patton picks up their first win as they keep Hickory winless as they defeated them 40-20. Wataga moves to 4-1 as they defeated St. Stephen's 34-14. And it's South Caldwell moving to 5-0 as they defeated High Brighton on Thursday night 20-16.
It was Mallard Creek over West Charlotte 42-13. Monroe beat Cupperson last night 31-7. It was Clinton over Pender County 64-13. Scotland County over Panther Creek 49-13. It was Asheville defeating Winston-Salem Carver 20-12. Asheville is the number 3A team in the state.
Yeah, I was surprised. I was talking about that Thursday. That game was going on Thursday night.
Yes.
And in Winston-Salem. And I just wonder how they got together. I mean, that just seems like an odd matchup to me that Asheville, yeah. You know, goes all the way. And obviously, there's probably a coaching connection there somehow. But Asheville going all the way to Winston to play Carver, a 3A against a 2A. And mm-hmm. Yeah, I like the matchup.
Oh, yeah,
good
I
game
do too.
For both. But it just seemed kind of odd. Carver led most of the game.
Yeah, they did. Well, Carver led Statesville last week, you know, and got beat at 10. Mm-hmm. But the losses for Winston-Salem Carver, 3-3. They've lost to Greensboro Dudley. They've lost to Statesville, and they've lost to Asheville.
So not losing the shabby competition. No. And that's what, like, with the game like with West Caldwell last night, their two losses came to South Caldwell and the High Brighton.
And for Crest, people, Havelock wins again, 41-6 over West Carnegat. They go to 6-0, and they're the number 2 3A team in the state. And Wallace Rose Hill over Heidi Trask, 62-19.
You know, you're talking about some of the games that have been put off to Monday night, and I'd heard all day, you know, about one game that's put off to Monday night. And then I was watching football Friday night, and they said, we'll be back with more highlights in a minute, including East Gaston at South Point. And I thought, y'all are good.
Yeah.
Y'all are good. Y'all going to supply highlights before 3 days before they play.
Wow. So. I told you all these games are fixed.
Speaking of East Gaston, good news this week. Robert Washington finally cleared by the state to play at East Gaston.
How about that?
You know, he won't be able to play probably until next Friday. Gets 8 practices in before, you know.
Well, Brett said he's going to practice 7 times today.
You know, we was discussing that last night, and I think him being cleared, they need him Monday.
Yeah, they do.
You know?
They can use any weapon they got.
That's what I'm saying. They need him then, but
just
I mean,
a little too late.
Yeah,
but they could use him on the defensive side too, because that's what's going to be tough. I mean, I think both of those offenses will really be tough to slow down in that game. East Gaston has a terrific passing game, a good passing offense. They're very impressed after I saw them play earlier in the year. But just some of the games last night, and you know, that. Go ahead, Terry.
I'm going to run down one guy, and I mean, we see him every week, and we talk about
he
him.
He must be slow.
Yeah, I'm telling you. But Coach Bice, I'll run you down, Coach. But anyway,
there's a chance.
Is that a challenge?
Coach Bice, I mean, he won his 26th straight conference game, you know, and he goes back, and I was pulling up.
It's impressive, said, in this conference.
Yeah, and he's like 114 and 30. 23 overall since he's arrived down there. But I went over some of the teams that he plays in this conference, and he is 42-15 against conference opponents
You're talking about. Yeah, I know. But right now you're talking about Lincoln, Maiden, New.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Teams that traditionally have strong teams and still hadn't lost one since he's been in this conference. That's pretty incredible.
The only team he has a losing record to overall that he's played is Newton Conover. Newton Conover's beat him 7 times. He's beat them 5. But
and that was back in his early days, too, when he took most of those losses.
He's 8-5 against Lincoln. He's 10-0 against West. He's 11-2 against Bandys. 3-1 against West Caldwell. 2-0 against Bunker Hill. 3-0 against Maiden. So
that's impressive. Mm-hmm. It really is. I mean, he has done a tremendous job. I looked at their roster the night. I did their game with Bandys on Thursday night. Rick and I, and I just wanted to look. And guess how many starters are on seniors starting on offense for that East Lincoln team this year?
I still remember because of COVID. 3
A whopping 3. Yeah. But now one of them happens to be Chaz Surratt.
Yeah.
One of them happens to be Chaz Surratt, which would make, that's going to be a huge blow when they lose him. But as good as they're doing and only 3 seniors on that offense, that's pretty good.
And I want to tell you guys, just watching the game the other night, it's the first time I've seen East Lincoln this year. I saw him about 5 times last year. Sage, when he gets the ball in the open field,
he can fly.
He
kicks in another gear.
And he's got the moves. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's really, really tough to bring down. So, Chaz is really great and all. He's not doing it by himself. These receivers are really good. And Cameron Dollar is way underlooked. I'd love to have Cameron Dollar as a wide receiver. And a lot of these other teams would, too. He'd start at Shelby.
And as a small forward.
Yeah. Sage really impressed me the other night on the little slants and the little seam routes when he caught it.
I would just about bet you from last year to this year, Sage has cut a half a second off his 40 time.
Think so?
I mean, he's faster than he was last year.
He looks, and
that comes with more maturity. I mean, as you get older, you get faster until you get mine and Terry's range.
Well, Terry's still hawking people down.
Terry is still running people down.
Still run them down.
One of them would be me right now. You don't have to go far. I'm not moving.
And I believe from last year, once Cameron Dollar made that spectacular catch in the state championship game, I was thinking he's going to break out in both football and basketball, I feel like, this year. And since it's his junior year, and you got to remember, both Cameron Dollar and Sage Surratt are only juniors.
Last year, Dollar on the basketball court was just inconsistent, and a lot of that's because it depends on how the game's dictated, and you know who's going to handle the ball and who's going to be the first option to shoot outside, and that's Surratt. But Cameron Dollar, he had a 27-point game.
Yeah, it's tough being a third option. It's tough being a third option and not being somebody that's like a 6'8", 6'9" guy who can get your own rebounds and get your own points that way.
Although he did some of that.
He did. He had to because the whole team did
rebounds. He's just real active.
But very, very good basketball.
Real active. He's just an all-around good athlete on that team. So I tell you what, East Lincoln, we don't have to worry about them. They're going to be very good. We're going to talk about them a little bit. We're going to talk about Shelby, and then we're going to talk about another 2A team that a lot of people aren't talking about right now, but could really be a thorn in the side of East Lincoln and Shelby when they get there, if they are all 3 in the same bracket. We'll take a timeout. Back with more sports talk in a moment.
The money you save in your savings accounts earns interest, so it just makes sense to have your checking account also earn interest for you. A money market checking account pays interest and also offers the flexibility of writing checks. Certain fees may apply. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings. I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country for a live ready remote broadcast this Saturday, September 26th at Quality Landscaping Materials. It's their gigantic grand opening event at the brand new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. You'll find landscape materials, storage buildings, and garages, plus stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more, and register to win some great prizes too. And Big O Country will be there broadcasting live from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have free hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there for the gigantic grand opening event at Quality Landscaping Materials. Now in the new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Come check it out right across from Tractor Supply. Call 704-862-0770 for more information or visit the website at QualityLandscapeMaterials.com.
Second down and six. Newton to throw. Looking end zone. And it is complete for a touchdown left side.
A beautiful
catch by Benjamin.
Carolina Panther in NFL football right here at Big O Country. WHS, WCSL, and WLON.
Mike Rowe here with Dave, an electrician with Mr. Sparky. Today, Dave is conducting an electrical safety inspection. Dave, how many of these have you done?
Thousands.
And have you ever found a home without any electrical problems?
Not yet.
Let me translate. If you live in a home and rely on electricity, call Mr. Sparky before something goes...
That's not what electricity sounds like, Mike.
No, but this is what a jingle sounds like.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Dave, is that you singing? Each independent franchise is licensed in its respective state or county. Mike Rowe here with Dave, an electrician with Mr. Sparky. Today, Dave is conducting an electrical safety inspection. Dave, how many of these have you done?
Thousands.
And have you ever found a home without any electrical problems?
Not yet.
Let me translate. If you live in a home and rely on electricity, call Mr. Sparky before something goes...
That's not what electricity sounds like, Mike.
No, but this is what a jingle sounds like.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Dave, is that you singing? Each independent franchise is licensed in its respective state or county.
Just arrived at Hojo Power Sports and Equipment in Shelby, the new Bobcat CRZ 48-inch zero-turn mower. And it's on sale for only $39.95. But that's not all. Get 0% financing for up to 54 months. Special financing also available on the Walker, Ferris, and Snapper mowers. Get your mower service too, with pickup and delivery available. Hojo Power Sports and Equipment. 110 Griggs Street off South Lafayette Street in Shelby.
That's smoke on the cowbell. More cowbell. I need more cowbell smoke.
Fever. Cowbell fever.
Is that not one of the most remembered scenes of television of all time? Probably one of the most played on YouTube too. Will Ferrell and the cowbell cracks me up no matter what he does. He's pretty impressive comedian to still be funny. How many years have you been in it? 20 or more?
More than that, probably.
Probably more than that. Oh man, been talking about some of these games, the weather, lots of things that are going on. A big game coming up this week, and I just got a text message from Athletic Director Cole Sigmund over at Langton. Said, folks going to the Langton East Lincoln game this coming week at Langton. Tickets will be on sale at the drugstore and at both schools, at East Lincoln High, at Langton High, and at the main drugstore there in Langton. And I'm assuming they'll be on sale probably as early as Monday morning, around 9 or 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
And if he's, excuse me, if he's listening and knows for sure that that'll be the time or wants to change it here, Kevin Ray, one can let me know. But advanced tickets, Langton, East Lincoln, that should be as good a crowd as that one,
yes,
as there was last night at Kings Mountain Shelby, even in the rain, even in the weather last night. Bad weather didn't keep the fans away from that game.
Yeah, all I got to say is if you're going to that game next week, you better get there early.
And it's just smart to get your ticket early,
yeah,
so you don't have to wait in line 30 minutes and miss half the first quarter, mm-hmm, you know? So. That to me, that's a big advantage. Or, folks, get the ticket early.
Or if it's both of those teams like the pass now, you may miss half the second quarter, about 30 minutes.
Actually, Coach Sigmund says they'll be on sale at the drugstore today. So you can get them as early as today. The tickets will be on sale today at the drugstore. And then at schools, of course, it don't matter if they're on sale today or not because school's out. Mm-hmm. So you got to wait till Monday if you're going to get them at one of the respective schools. East Lincoln looked impressive on Thursday night. Out at Bandy's, I just feel for those guys right now. They're struggling to put points on the board. They don't have a real good passing game. Their touchdown came on a trick play, a halfback pass for a 19-yard touchdown. They even ran that play a couple times to get first downs. They're just having to do gimmicks to even move the ball. East Lincoln, you know, starting to do like they did last year. The defense is starting to gel. I mentioned you guys only got three seniors on offense. Well, they got six on that defense. And the defense, to me, is doing what it did a year ago. They're just starting to get a little better each game. And, you know, last year by playoff time, I would say by round two in the playoffs or three, their defense was every bit as good as their offense, which says a lot about that team last year. So they have impressed me on both sides of the ball, obviously. But, Jason, have you seen East Lincoln?
Yeah, I saw
him. And Kevin has, and Evan has. I want to ask you questions. Is there a more – I don't want to say dynamic, but a is there a better coached passing game or in around than what East Lincoln does? I mean, it is just like it's almost like they run their routes so well. It's like they draw it on paper. Chasserat knows where everybody's going to be at every time, and he's always got that safety valve because he's always got Colton Banks swinging out of the backfield. And if he don't throw it to him right away, he can look at three or four receivers and then swing it out to him. And it's like you're so busy covering the guys downfield, you forget about Banks coming out of there.
Yeah.
Well, to me, as far as the wide receivers, Cameron Dollard and Sage make a lot of difference. He had no receivers out there.
They stretch it.
I mean, Brandon Littlejohn at Burns was really good. He would have his receivers 8 to 10 drops a game, and it just it killed him. These guys don't drop the ball, so it helps Chaz a lot. Now, what he's doing, he takes his, you know, his 3-5-step drop. He reads the one side of the field. What it reminds me a lot of is the Michael Vick days in Atlanta. He would read that seam route for Sage, look backside for the other one if he wasn't there, and then he could either roll out or dump it to the running back. He's got 1, 2, 3 options. He's so fast and the receivers are so good, it's really hard to stop.
And just think about option number 6.
Yeah, I mean, that's run the ball. First two. Yeah. We've got 3 other people that could be sitting there wanting to pass.
Option 6 to run it might be the scariest one of all.
And his accuracy is even better this season for Chaz. I mean, he's not putting his receivers in harm's way, you know, throwing them too high, too low, or stretching them out too far. And then, like I said, with Banks, you know, the dump down, the swing, the little passes out to the flats, or the little flare routes out to the flats.
They use that a lot as the running game, too. My biggest concern is will they need at some point a power running game where they have to get some yardage, have to run the clock? Last year in the championship game, they ran Chaz pretty much as a wildcat, basically. There at the end of the game, running out. Is that what's going to have to go to? Can Banks handle that load when it gets down to it and you have to pound it in between the tackles or run that clock? What do you think, Jerry?
I don't know. I mean,
he's so good. I mean, it might not matter.
Well, we're hearing it from both sides.
Shelby.
We're hearing it from both sides. We're hearing it from Shelby. We're hearing it from East Lincoln. They're going to have a better running game. Yeah. Well, you know, these guys are coming off of state championships and they're doing the same thing they did last year. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So. Yeah. I don't, you know. Was they closer games last year for East Lincoln? They was. Washington was able to play with them. For Shelby, I mean, not really. So, good question.
I think the biggest thing that, as far as the quarterbacks goes, Chaz's experience in everything that he's done is going to be a little bit of an advantage over Darquez Lee's. Darquez, with all the talent in the world, you know, big, big, fast, strong, can sling it. You know, at some point, you know, he's only his fifth and sixth game quarterback, and overall, you know, Chaz's been doing this for years. And we saw last night, you know, he had some rain, a really big game. He started off 5-for-20 a lot of times.
It affected him.
He was off. It seemed like he was just overthrowing. He's got a great arm. How many times, David, you see, you know, the ball just outside the reach of the receiver's hands?
All his misses. All his misses were high.
And see, any of that could be inexperience. He's never played quarterback. He's never played a downpour like that. It's hard to throw in the rain. You don't know. So little things like that could affect that. But he's got 5 wide receivers. Chaz got 2. But it's going to be such a great matchup.
I would love to see. But I mean, we keep saying this, and don't get me wrong, I'd rather see it in a regular season than see it in a playoff. Mm-hmm. But when we see it, y'all, I mean, think about what's going to happen. All the passes that's going to be in that game and all the talent that is out there on the field. Can either one of them, or are they going to face a team that they're doing the same thing to, of pass, 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 and you're going to have the same option on the other side? Do we have enough defenders to be able to stop something?
Chaz played a lot of defense the other night. But think about it, he plays safety, he'll play defense. That defensive end, line, they put him in on third down and long at defensive end.
He can rush the quarterback.
He went right around that end the other night. Rush. It was just incredible.
They do that both with Sage and Cameron Dollar too, so they'll use all 3 of those guys sometimes at defensive end. So
get some speed on that
over under if they did play over under on interceptions in that game, because both teams got some really good defensive backs.
And, they've both been throwing some picks too.
Yeah,
they've both been throwing some picks.
There's going to be
I'd say five would be your over under. Yeah. But you'd hope not. But Terry, one thing about it, I know you said you'd like to see them meet in the regular season, and we know that's not going to happen. They don't schedule each other. But the good thing about it, if they do meet in the playoffs, it's probably going to be late in the season, and it's probably going to be one of them we know will be guaranteed probably a spot in the state championship. Mm-hmm. Now, that thorn in the side I wanted to talk about is Monroe. You know, a lot of Monroe's the last team to beat East Lincoln.
Yeah, East don't want to hear that name. Chaz don't want to hear that
name. In 2013, East Lincoln was beaten by Monroe on the road in the second or third round of the playoffs.
It was the third round. That was mainly due because East Lincoln had the forfeit their non-conference schedule due to an ineligible player.
Made them go on the road.
Yeah.
But Monroe's looking pretty good. They beat two 3A ranked teams this year in Weddington and Cuthbertson, and they're looking pretty good. And I'm sure that, those East Lincoln guys can't help but think in the back of their mind, they're looking at them Monroe scores.
Oh, they are. And one team I know that don't want to play them again is Hunter Huss.
That one was bad.
Hey, that was ugly.
Yep, that was bad. But I tell you, we talk about how our counties have come a long way, and they have. You know, Cleveland's been good for years. Lincoln County's, come up, with two incredible teams that have making some serious runs in the state championship play as well. And of course, down in Gaston County, we have, of course, South Point, who's right in the mix every year. We've seen Ashbrook win state title in football as well. And in Catawba County, we know about the history up there, with Maiden, Newton, Bandies, and those guys. But Union County, to me, in the last 5 years, has really come on the scene. I mean, first of all, it's the fastest growing county in the state of North Carolina. And they build high school after high school after high school. And all these high schools they build, bam, they're instantly good in athletics.
Mm-hmm.
And they've just had some teams to come on the scene the last few years with Monroe, Cuthbertson, Weddington, who have made some noise
in the
playoffs.
They build the schools near the athletes' houses.
Evidently.
It's a 5-star recruit over there. Let's put a 2A high school right there.
But you have to start when he's 6. So the house will be done. Have to start when he's 6 years old to get school will be finished.
My biggest thing I'm looking at right now, and I'm interested to see how far they can go, is Cleveland County's undefeated streak right now. Haven't lost to anyone but in county.
But Cleveland County.
Right now. So let's see if they can make it through the SMAC conference. And if they do that, I mean, that'll just be amazing.
It will, but if you take a look at that conference and that schedule, are they not going to be the top four?
They should be the top four.
You know what I mean?
But what I'm saying is, will they be undefeated in everywhere but Cleveland County?
I think so. I mean, I shouldn't say I think so, but I think there's a real good chance. I think there's
Can anybody outside of Cleveland County be the Cleveland County team?
Can East come in and do it?
And it's going to be East Rutherford or East Burke.
East Burke.
One of the two.
Monday night, Terry? Is that what you're
That's
saying?
That's what's going to happen.
what was y'all talking about?
Don't y'all throw stuff at me over there.
Now, I heard Jim Chad talk about that last night. He had some type of – who's Simpson? Who's Webb Simpson's He had the spreads on them. And I think Burns and
East Oh, no, not Webb Simpson. That's just that Simpson report.
I've never heard of that.
That guy does that thing nationally. He's got some kind of mass stuff that he does. And
he's got Burns by eight.
But Terry's going to start giving the Reinhardt.
That's right. This week I'm going to start doing it.
The Reinhardt Index.
Well, I like to see that one.
It's getting hot.
That'd be a good one. I'm going to talk about some other games. We got on East Lincoln. We talked about Shelby some, and we may hear from Lance Ware in a little while. And if we do, we'll discuss his game with him. If we don't,
he's
we'll discuss
still
his game.
Off.
He may be. Discuss
Lance Ware went to 5-0 against
I'll tell you something else, too.
Yeah.
They suffered a couple of injuries last night that guys, I don't know if they'll be back for a while. I mean, these were injuries on the field that took 10 to 15 minutes, two of them, to get these guys off. But now what I was more impressed with last night from Shelby than anything, because I hadn't heard about it all year, their running game's good.
Oh yeah.
If they want to run the ball, they can run the ball for 300 yards a game.
So they got
some backs. Brooks and Sims, I think it is, 13 and 14. And Sims was one of the kids that got hurt late in that game.
That was kind of where I was going with the whole East Lincoln Shelby thing, is that if they do match up and get down to it, if you got to run the ball, can East do it?
East has a pretty good one, too, in Banks.
Just as well against Shelby. Now, Shelby, what they're missing right now, Dave, and you didn't get to see, is the Calvin Camp kid.
Right.
He's an outstanding runner.
And he is expected to come back, right?
Yeah, he's supposed to be back for maybe the last game or two, maybe playoffs, maybe Lance can clear that up.
Is it collarbone?
I think it's collarbone. I mean, from what I've seen, I saw him last year, and then what I've seen this year with Shelby, I mean, he was outstanding, and they still had those five wide receivers.
And I like the two backs they play.
Yeah.
I really like the two backs. You know, you were talking about your back-breaking play last night in that game.
Was the player of the game last night for us.
Yeah, was the throw. I thought maybe the back-breaker play in that game was that kickoff return.
Yeah.
Because that thing bounced and bounced and bounced and bounced, and nobody following on it, and all of a sudden Brooks scoops it up, and bam, he's gone down the left sideline and takes it to the house.
He's not had a lot of heartbreaking plays, it seemed like.
They overran the plays, what happened.
Yeah.
If you look at it, I bet you look on your video, they overran the play. Mm-hmm. And then, because the ball was bouncing, they were trying to get it. And when they overran it, bam, he's got like three guys to beat. But I was impressed with that. Another local team here, Maiden, they continue to roll. They struggled early in that game with Bunker Hill. We know Bunker Hill's offense can score. We talked about that. Maiden does win. They lost a week ago to Sal Caldwell, but they come back with the win a couple nights ago over Bunker Hill, 46-23.
27 straight.
27 times in a row they beat Bunker. West Caldwell last night with impressive win over Newton Conover. We thought this might be the year that West Caldwell kind of turned that corner, you know, and started getting some wins in the conference. Now, I don't know if you guys know the answer to this or not. I'm assuming that the West Caldwell quarterback that's been injured played last night.
Titus Tucker, yes, he played last night. Okay. He's quarterback.
Because he's why they couldn't score the last 3 weeks. Yeah. He wasn't in the quarterback spot.
Okay, and I see why now. He's quarterback. Return man, safety, punter.
I heard y'all mention that.
Yeah, and he ran the opening kickoff back last night, 97 yards.
Bus then, driver, shoe salesman.
Then on the ensuing drive, on the ensuing kickoff, they pooch kick it. You know, it's raining, it's a wet football, and Newton Conover can't feel it. They recover at the Newton 39 and score like 3 minutes later.
Yeah.
Then Newton finally gets on the board. Their offense gets going. And late in the game, Newton takes the lead, go up 30-29, and first time they had trailed that West Caldwell had trailed, but they came back and answered.
Is that the only lead of the game?
That was their only lead.
The only lead was 30-29.
Yeah.
How about that?
But running backs in that game, running back for Newton, sophomore Tyler Stinson had 37 carries for 244 yards. I think I had him down at.
Wow.
And then the running back for West Caldwell, Tristan Harper, two touchdowns for Stinson. Tristan Harper had, I want to say, 24 carries, and had him about 158 with 3 touchdowns.
That Harper kid, that's the same kid that pitched for West Caldwell and pitched for Post 29.
Might be.
They had a Harper kid that did, and I think it was. He's just a good all-around athlete.
Now, that game had a little bit of controversy. If anybody knows a little bit about the backstory, apparently West Caldwell had some players get in trouble this week.
Right.
And according to sources and other things, apparently there was some shoplifting at Belk's. I don't know if there was an actual arrest or not.
It doesn't seem like there was an arrest.
Trouble. I heard shoplifting at Belk's. Wasn't told if there was an actual arrest on it or not.
Don't see anything about any arrests or any charges being filed.
Well, apparently Newton wanted to move the game up to Thursday to play to get out of the rain in like East Lincoln and Bandy's, and then apparently West Caldwell didn't want the game moved at all, and so that was you have to have both coaches agree to it, and apparently West Caldwell, part of it, they wanted some of these players back from some type of school suspension or something like that to get them back in the game. So, a little bit of controversy there for you Newton and West Caldwell fans.
And then we had an official get injured in the game
I heard y'all talking about that. What happened?
I think I saw on Football Friday Night, he just tripped over and face-planted, looks like.
He's running down. It was a big play.
I hope he's not listening this morning.
Nice matter. Well, we had an official injured. face-planted.
I hope he's not listening this morning.
It was a big play. It was 89. It was a dump down pass, yeah. And it went 89 yards, and the official's running down the sideline. The receiver, Elijah Brooks, he's pulling a little bit of a Reggie Bush, running down the sideline, stopped cutting back across the field and everything. And the official was down on the West Caldwell bench around the 25-yard line. And he said, like, what happened? And they threw a flag, and they called an unsportsmanlike penalty. I take it the players, somebody had to be out of the box.
Yeah.
So that's
was it run into somebody?
Yeah.
Then? Okay.
Yeah.
Tough break either way. But
I thought he got, the RG3 meme where the song
cold. No.
I thought he got shook by a punt returner or something.
Well, also, another thing that I've forgot to mention was the last night that hurt Newton Conover. Some drives that they had going, they had penalties hurt those drives. And I think that was another factor in the game last night.
Penalties and special teams were the two things that got.
That seems to hurt a lot of teams. A lot of games I've seen this year, that has really been a setback, you know, because a lot of teams, and, you know, some teams can overcome 5-yard illegal procedure penalties and get a first down, but teams that predominantly run, it's a little tougher on them. But you know, those holding calls and those things like that to put you back 10, 15 yards, that kills you.
Well, what hurt Newton really right before the half, they were inside the inside the red zone right before half, and they were going to get the ball to start the second half kickoff, and they pick up it was second and 11 around the 15, and they pick up a 5-yard offsides, moving back, and it ended up being about a fourth and 15 they were going for, and they couldn't get any points right before the half.
In the conference, that's a huge win for West Caldwell, though, because that might put them, in the upper four in that group when everything's said and done. And plus, they already hold the head-to-head now over Newton Conover, too. So, you know, Newton's kind of got to win, gain two games on them to be ahead of them.
Hey, it's going to be tough getting in the playoffs now.
Well, that's exactly what we was talking about last night because you've got
– it's going to be really tough.
They cannot lose to Bandys. They cannot lose to Bunker Hill, and they cannot lose to West Lincoln because – you're going to have East Lincoln to play, Maiden to play, and Lincoln in the play.
Yep.
And those are going to be a hard competition to beat anyway.
And they play Maiden next week, and then so, the week after Maiden. That, West Lincoln.
Yeah, and if you do get in, a lot of teams after the first three, I think, get seeded out of that conference. The rest are wild cards, so wild card means automatic road game.
And a lot of teams last year that was in this conference that was 2-5 in the conference did not make the playoffs.
Right, right. Shelby last night, 34-20 over Kings Mountain in the swamp, as we'll call it, the swamp over in Kings Mountain. It, you know, for the most part of the game, I stood out in it. It really wasn't that bad. There was like one time during the game that it rained pretty hard. The rest of the time, it was just a light mist, and you know, but
inside the booth, it looked like it was just coming out in sheets.
Yeah, at one time,
the wind was blowing. You know, that's like, what was killing it. The wind was blowing. It was like Forrest Gump. You know, when it rained sideways, is what it looked like.
That's what it was.
I've always told folks, a lot of times you can look under the lights and you can see rain, and it's rain you don't even feel. It's so light, but the lights make it show up. But for the most part last night, now what really got bad in the second half, the wind picked up quite a bit. And I think the wind affected the passing game a little bit for both of these teams. But
kudos to any coaches, cameraman, anybody on top of the roofs last night.
Yeah, you got that right.
You had a struggle this weekend. One guy last night was on a scissor lift down at Kings Mountain before he went out. I said, good luck, brother.
And he had an umbrella about this big around. Size of a plate. He had an umbrella about the size of a plate.
Well, if he had a bigger one, it might have blew him off the tower.
Yeah. He parachute down. They did have like a little awning tent or something, like
they
canvas
had a back tent. But I mean, like I said, when it started raining sideways,
it didn't
matter at all.
Crest RS Central, while I'm on this page, that one is going to be Monday night, as well as Burns East Burke, Chase and Drone. Tell you what, we'll talk a little bit about some of these Northern Piedmont games as well. The North Lincoln game.
Dave, before you go.
Yes.
Keep going. Before you went back, I had a couple things I want to go over.
Now, I'm ready to take a break because when we come back, we'll look at a whole different conference. So,
real quick, I want to go over next week's schedule, and we will have a new number one to the What's Up Shopper Power Poll next week for the first time this year. The Shelby Golden Lions will be number one. Next week, East Rutherford at Burns, Chase at Crest, East Burke at Shelby, Mooresville at North Lincoln, East Lincoln at Lincolnton, North Gaston at Ashbrook, and the Cherville Ironmen are open. So that's our KTC schedule. We'll talk a little bit more about that later in the show on where you can find those games. But Shelby going to number one in the power poll.
And well-deserved at this point, no doubt. Back with more sports talk in a moment.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings. I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country for a live-ready remote broadcast. This Saturday, September 26th, at Quality Landscaping Materials. It's their gigantic grand opening event at the brand new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. You'll find landscape materials, storage buildings, and garages, plus stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more, and register to win some great prizes, too. And Big O Country will be there broadcasting live from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have free hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there for the gigantic grand opening event at Quality Landscaping Materials. Now in the new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Come check it out right across from Tractor Supply. Call 704-862-0770 for more information or visit the website at QualityLandscapeMaterials.com. It's time to get your flu shot. Plan now to visit Falston Pharmacy in Falston and get your flu shots. Only $29.99 or they will bill your Medicare or Blue Cross Blue Shield. Come on in for all the details. Again, only $29.99 for your flu shot.
Don't miss work because of the flu. Fallston Pharmacy in Fallston has a flu shot for you. They'll even come to your business, church, or school. Fallston Pharmacy, located on Highway 18 North in Fallston. Use their convenient drive-through window. But get your flu shots today at the Fallston Pharmacy. Set up your appointment by calling 704-538-3021. Get your flu shots today. The 91st Annual Cleveland County Fair returns October 1st through the 11th at the Cleveland County Fairgrounds. Special fair days include Fair Appreciation Day October 1st, Armband Day October 3rd and 10th, Half Price Sunday on October 4th and 11th, plus Dollar Day Monday and $10 Buck Tuesday, and Faith and Family Night. And the Demolition Derby returns October 3rd and 10th. Don't miss it, the 91st Annual Cleveland County Fair, October 1st through the 11th at the Cleveland County Fairgrounds. Barrett Floor Covering in Kings Mountain has some new products that you'll want to see, like the new IVC Luxury Vinyl Tile and Plank with a 20-year residential warranty. It's durable and tough and 100% water-resistant. And see the new Armstrong Lux Plank, perfect for baths, kitchens, laundry rooms, and basements, and 100% waterproof, too. See both today at Barrett Floor Covering, 150 Dixon School Road in Kings Mountain. Call 704-739-4581. See them for all of your carpet and flooring needs. Only $149 per month. Lease and ride for only $149 per month at Carter Chevrolet in Shelby. All for good on the 015 Chevrolet Cruze LT, the 015 Chevrolet Trax LT, the 015 Chevrolet Malibu, and the 015 Chevrolet Equinox. Come on in for all the details. And be sure to see Carter Chevrolet at this year's Cleveland County Fair. Your discount Chevy store is Carter Chevrolet, 200 West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, online at CarterChev.com.
There you go, Ann. Your new account is now open. Just one more little thing. Here's your card. What was that?
It's my new bank. Every time I turn around, I get hit with another fee.
You need to get an account at Carolina Federal Credit Union.
She's right.
Tired of getting hit by bank fees? Switch to Carolina Federal Credit Union today. Make those pains go away.
Here's your receipt.
Like it's going to be a wet day all day. I don't know how much of the nation's covered in rain, but could affect some college football outcomes with the weather that we have to deal with today. We're going to continue our march through the high school football games from last night. We'll give all the scores again probably in our next segment. Glad to have you with us this morning on Sports Talk, though. It's Kevin, Terry, David, Jason, and Evan the Smoke on the board this morning here. Glad to have you with us. I mentioned a couple of games coming up Monday night. Crest, RS Central, Burns, East Burke, Drone, and Chase. Mooresville and Statesville in the Northern Piedmont 3A, 4A. Thursday night, I think it was, South Iredale beat Alexander Central in that conference 54-27. And also, North Lincoln, a school record, 70 points on Thursday night as they defeat North Iredale 70-49. If I'm not mistaken, I think they had a touchdown and a safety in the last 11 seconds of the first half.
Yeah, they got a safety with 11 seconds left, and then on the kick, they got to the 50 on the kickoff, and Reed McCrory threw a 42-yard touchdown pass, or close to that, to Jimmy Scott. Coming into the game, they only had 39 passing yards, so they eclipsed the passing yards on one play.
Somebody had to pile up some stats in that game as well. There had to be some big-time numbers in that game. I don't know if you know any, or I don't have anything in front of me.
J-Mo Thompson had about 217 yards. Stevie Jackson had about 170-something, I believe. But they had a total of 508 team rushing yards. And in the last 2 weeks, they've had 496 2 weeks ago against Bessemer City, 508 this past week against North Iredale. So they've almost had 1,000 rushing yards total for the team in the past 2 weeks alone.
The only thing that wasn't racked up in that game was tackle totals. Not a lot of tackle totals. Well, Terry led the team in tackles that night, didn't you, Terry?
Okay.
You'll take it. Lake Norman also beat West Iredale 36-6. That's another team out of that conference. Big South 2A, 3A. Most of them are Monday night, but this was an interesting matchup, and I wanted to pay attention to this one last night. Ashbrook playing Kramer, and Kramer coming in with that 3-1 record. But Ashbrook just hammered them. I mean, just pounded them last night on the road, on the turf. Ashbrook moves to 3-2. Kramer falls to 3-2. Both teams now 3-2, but Ashbrook gets the upper hand in the conference with a 39-0 win against Kramer. Not surprised at all that Ashbrook won the game. I am a little surprised maybe by the margin and about the shutout.
Yeah, you know, it's like the first big test, you know, going against a traditional Gaston County team. So first test for them. But
yeah, that's my surprise tonight. I mean, it really is what you just said, David.
The difference. Yeah, the differential.
Yeah, totally. I mean, Stuart Kramer's looked good. Everybody was excited. Maybe they could compete in the Big South. And
Ashbrook, we know, every time they march a team out on the field, it's just loaded with athletes. Yeah. I mean, they have a ton of athletes. As many, they can match any team in our area, athlete for athlete. It's just a matter of getting the most out of them and getting them to play and put games together. And last night looks like probably their best one so far here. I know we're just only about halfway, but that's the first conference game for these guys, right?
First conference.
So it looks like they may be hitting their stride at the right time. And we'll see. You know, as time goes, will they be able to compete with South Point down the road? Because still, to me, South Point's the favorite in this conference. And speaking of the Red Raiders, they didn't get to play last night. They'll play Monday night at 7:30 as they host East Gaston. Big rivalry game there.
East Gaston looking for their first win since 2006 against South Point.
And, yeah, and that's yeah, this would be, what, the 10th straight.
Well, they keep building schools in East Gaston's district.
Well, the good news is they're not 4A.
Yeah.
But the bad news is some players going away as well, I guess. Lake Norman Charters at Forest View, that one also Monday night. Hunter Huss and North Gaston is Monday night. And you know what? I think East Gaston will score some points just because their offense is so good against South Point. I don't know how many times they'll be able to stop South Point's vaunted running game, but I also think Hunter Huss North Gaston is going to be a good game, a good matchup there on paper as well. Southern Piedmont 1A, Highland Tech and Bessemer, that one's moved to Monday night at 7:00. Mountain Island, they've changed their name to Tech now, Terry.
Mountain Island Tech Charter.
Mountain Island Charter was defeated last night by Community School of Davidson. They're trying to go out there in disguise.
That's what it is.
But Community School of Davidson 57-0 last night. Mountain Island Charter, you know, had high hopes coming into the season. But it has not worked out for them at all. Not at all.
Some of those articles in the Gazette ain't looking too great now.
Nah, they were hyped. That was the all hype team.
First year school, getting all these transfer players.
And they're going to win the Southern Piedmont 1A, too. Right.
Sometimes it just don't work out. And this is one of their cases. Now under a new coach, too.
Robert Washington Sr.
Yep. A couple weeks ago, changed coaches. But so far, it hadn't had an effect, at least on the scoreboard. Forbush, Cherville Road last night, what, hour and a half, 2 hours up to Forbush, only to get shut out by the Falcons up there, 40-0.
Rough year
in that non-conference game. It is. You know, Cherville to me is comparable to Bandy's, you know, with struggling to score points. And you know, Bandy's defense may be a little better than Cherville's, but it's just been that kind of year so far for the Ironmen. And Pine Lake Prep, also a member of the Southern Piedmont 1A, they win last night against Concord First Assembly, I guess that is.
Yes. Terry's abbreviation on this one.
Put that one up as a Sports Center highlight on the screen behind. They whipped their assembly last night. I got so tied up, I don't even know if I gave the score. 32-20. 32-20 in that one. I love it. I love the abbreviation there, Terry. Northwestern 4A, our final conference here this morning to look at some of the games. I'm very impressed with the Freedom team on Thursday night. They won this game. Most of these games were Thursday, right?
Yeah.
But St. Stephen's were talking.
Okay. But Freedom 47-7 against Fred T. Ford. Obviously, they were, you know, heavily favored in that game. But, you know, Freedom now 4-1, only loss was to a good Shelby team, and they were in that game till the very end.
B.J. Emmons only run the ball 8 times.
How many have?
279 yards.
You know,
5 touchdowns.
Marcus Murray had 8 carries.
That's
Sunday.
What I'm saying.
You guys, I know you guys remember, but Goo Wyatt, that's the kind of numbers he used to put up in playoffs.
Yeah.
He'd have 7 carries and over 200 yards, and by halftime he didn't carry the ball anymore. But, yeah, those are just ridiculous numbers. Patton, a 40-20 win over Hickory. Hickory still winless on the season. They play another winless team and get beat by 20. So Hickory's woes continue in that Northwestern 3A, 4A. Also, Thursday night, South Caldwell beat High Brighton. That game, that's huge because you got to think South Caldwell, High Brighton, or Freedom is going to be the conference champion. So that's a big win for South Caldwell on the road, not only against a conference rival, but against a county rival as well up there in Caldwell County. So big win for those guys. If we didn't mention your team, a lot of teams were off. Thomas Jefferson, East Rutherford, West Lincoln, and Lincoln were some of the teams in our area that did have the night off. And they'll be back into action this coming week as well. Any thoughts from you guys on any of these games? Something I left out? Something you guys would like to mention or anything?
Monday night we will have a broadcast, live broadcast of the Burns and the Crest games. We will not have a pregame or postgame show Monday night. But, folks, the Crest game, Terry, what's the times on those real quick? I think Crest plays at 6.
Yeah, they are kind of mixed up, so all jumbled
up. Crest at RS Central will go on the air live on the internet, folks, at 5 o'clock. So 5 p.m. sharp. The Crest pregame show will begin, and they'll play at 6. And, Terry, the other one was Monday at 7, Burns at East Burke. They won't go on the air, though, folks, until 6:30. So 5 o'clock, tune in for the Crest pregame and the Crest start. And then after that, once that gets going and maybe Crest's up by 40 or 50, you can switch over to watch Burns and East Burke, which should be, as Terry says, a slobber knocker up in East Burke.
That saying come from I know it was way back, but Lewis is one. Lewis is just such a loyal guy. He loves high school football, and he sends me a text every Friday. Where are you going tonight? You know, and then I'll be listening, all this kind of stuff, and he just listens and loves it. And this week, you know, poor old Lewis, he can't get out right now because of his health, so he's not getting out a lot. And I hope Lewis is listening this morning because you know we all love him to death. But he loves this sport, and anytime he gets some rainouts, he's in heaven because he gets more games. He gets more games over the weekend that he can.
Well, I know he said that his boy Matt was coming in for the Lincoln and East Lincoln game, and he's hoping to get to that game coming up this week. So,
my guess is Lewis is still asleep right now, though. He, believe it or not, Lewis is a night owl. Yeah. He likes to stay up late and sleep late. So I don't blame him. I don't blame him one bit for that. I really don't. Well, there's a rundown of our high school football. We'll maybe get some coaches' calls here in a little bit. If we do, we'll gladly talk to them. We'll come back. We'll run down next week's games. Maybe preview the conferences a little bit because now teams are really getting into conference play. I know we might be a little late on some of those conference previews, but, you know, it's a good time of year. We've played 6 weeks almost, got Monday night to go, and then we'll have 6 weeks to go in the regular season. So we're halfway through the regular season, about a third way through the entire high school season. Back with more in a moment.
You care about the future of this community. You grew up here. You've raised a family here. Your life is here. So is ours. Carolina Trust Bank. Member FDIC.
Who shall separate us now?
Clemson, here we come!
No one.
As they take the 2014 Russell Athletic Bowl.
Our Tigers are ready to streak to the top of the ACC and beyond. Clemson football lives here on the Clemson Tigers Sports Network.
Clemson Tiger football right here on Big O Country. WHS Shelby, WCSL Cherryville Gastonia, WLON Lincoln.
Hey Braves Country, bring your family and friends to Turner Field to celebrate 50 seasons of Atlanta Braves baseball and save money with the Chevron Family Value Plan. For as little as $69, you get 4 Braves tickets, 4 hot dogs, 4 Cokes, free parking, a Braves yearbook, and a $10 Chevron promo card.
Here's the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Jim Johnson strikes out the side in the 8th inning.
See the Braves' best games this season and save with the Chevron Family Value Plan. Visit Braves.com/specials today.
It's the 91st Annual Cleveland County Fair, October 1st through the 11th. This year's theme is Locally Sown, Locally Grown, with a tribute to the Foothills Farmers Market. Bring the family for great free entertainment, including the Zerbini Family Circus, the Barnyard Review, Leon Jacobs, the Kenya Safari Acrobats, The Tiger Encounter, Act Monster, Chainsaw Demonstration, and Extreme Illusions and Escapes with Josh and Leah Knott. Don't miss it, the 91st Annual Cleveland County Fair, October 1st through the 11th at the Cleveland County Fairgrounds. Introducing the ultimate work all ATV, the all-new Kodiak 700s at full-throttle power sports. The Kodiak 700s deliver big-bore performance at a mid-bore price, starting under $7,000. With class-leading power, automatic transmission, rear-sealed wet brake and more, the Kodiak 700 is unbeatable. Visit Full Throttle Power Sports today. Yamaha ATVs, real world tough. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 off I-85 at 100 Indian Walk in Lowell. Online at ncfullthrottle.com.
It's Big Time Revelry at the Renaissance Festival. Open Saturdays and Sundays, now through November 22nd.
You laugh so hard, you'll wet yourself.
The Carolina Renaissance Festival, a medieval amusement park, 12 stages, comedy, daredevil antics,
jousting nights.
Come frolic in the woods.
Incredible value, wondrous entertainment, and delicious food.
New Queen's Kitchen Pub, the Edgewood Theater, and stage entertainments.
I love the giant turkey leg.
Huzzah!
Great escape. You will love it.
The Renaissance Festival is back. Saturdays and Sundays now through November 22nd. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter stores or print yours online at RenFestInfo.com. Presented by Pepsi.
The 2015 Renaissance Festival, October 4th through November 22nd.
Let's see. What we got?
No, just read it.
Hold on, hold on.
Yeah, read what it says.
Can't see it. There you go. That's awesome.
Of course. Sism.
Welcome back to Sports Talk, the only show in the nation that...
world.
This is definitely the only show like this in the world. There's no doubt, because we have the one and only Terry Reinhart.
Exactly.
And no other show.
You know the neat thing about
we're going to let you tell you the truth.
There's not one.
This is the only show in the galaxy, Terry. Do you know the thing about that? Radio waves, they go on forever. Mm. So somewhere, some civilization, if there is some, or will be in the future, will hear you talking about sports.
I get your point now. Somebody on Mars understands Terry.
Yeah.
To be honest with you.
To be honest with you.
All it takes is one.
Oh, you know, his happy birthday shout outs. Forgot to mention one special shout out to one Miss Serena Williams. Today is her birthday as well. Yes, she turned 34 today as well. So.
All right. We are, I hope I didn't overlook this. I just now looked at my phone, but we are going to check in with Calvin this morning, who is at Quality Landscaping Materials in Gastonia. What's up, Calvin?
Hey, thank you there, David. We are at Quality Landscaping Materials, and Mr. Perkins, this is your first time being here, right?
Yes, it is, but it won't be my last. I'm coming to get mulch. I'm getting flowers. They got some beautiful stuff around here.
Yeah, they do. You're going to get a pansy?
I'm going to get a bunch of pansies.
He's going to get a pansy.
That one's going to have to walk itself. I'm not letting him ride with me.
Oh, okay. Just going to check and see.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wow. Woo! Got a little wind
felt,
blowing up.
Felt good.
It did. All right, we're at Quality Landscape Materials. Again, it's a grand opening today, and we're located at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard right here in Gastonia. We're going to be here till 2 o'clock today. We got papers blowing everywhere. We better put those up. But come out and see us and register to win. We got some Renaissance Festival tickets we're giving away. We've got Cleveland County Fairground tickets. We got free rounds of golf at Craters Mountain Golf Course, $25 gift card to Newt's, and some What's Up Shopper t-shirts. And Perk Inside, they've got some goodies that they're going to be giving away too. You don't have a mic. Okay. All right. He's picking up papers that's blown across the parking lot. All right. They've got, looks like, T-shirts. They've also got some cakes and cupcakes and cookies and, let's see, some sunglasses. Some T-shirts. We mentioned the T-shirts. Got some sunglasses and some other goodies. So come on by and get you a free Subway sandwich.
That's right. And they've got candy in there. They've got some cupcakes. Some of the best-looking cupcakes I've seen, Calvin.
Yep. And we want to thank Al Long at Subway in Boger City and Walmart in Lincoln for providing our Subway sandwiches today. So we appreciate
indeed.
That.
And they'll be here shortly, won't
they? They'll be here about 10 o'clock.
Mama's out running for us this morning.
She's on the road right now, just
like
Willie.
That's a good thing.
All right, come see us. We're at Quality Landscape Materials. Again, it's 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply, right down below Food Line. You can't miss it. All right, guys, we'll send it back to you.
All right, go check in a little later with Calvin and Perk down there in Gastonia. Please go by and check them out today. Quality Landscaping Materials on West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. I'm sure you know where it is.
And if that slips you by, pick up a What's Up shopper around town in your area. And on page 6, it'll give you the directions and everything you need to know to find Calvin in the game.
And a nice colorful ad there check out as well. Welcome back to Sports Talk. Must be sponsored by Nabisco this morning. But a lot of Cookie Monsters in here. I don't know who supplied those, but they've become a good friend of mine.
Thanks.
Bringing in the cookies. Give us the sugar rush to carry us through the next 35-40 minutes, whatever it is we got left this morning. And talking through about some of these high school football games, and it's been pretty impressive. Halfway point, guys. We are 6 weeks in. With 6 weeks to go in the regular season, any surprises up or down for you guys at this point?
I've got two.
Lay them on.
Number one, West Caldwell defeating Newton. I think they kind of put themselves in, a little bit more to deal with this year than what we have been. And on the other end, Stuart Kramer not showing up against Ashbrook. I think a lot of people thought Stuart Kramer would be a little bit better this year, but.
But I mean,
not
like,
to show.
I meant surprises after. I know what you're saying last night, but after six games, is anybody surprised you where the Kings Mountain to me has been a pleasant surprise. They lost last night, but guys are 5-1.
Yeah,
I mean they should be very proud of that record. East Burke, I think what they've done, the turnaround they've made in the first 6 weeks of the season.
Drawn.
Also 3-2. 3-2.
Bunker Hill doing pretty solid this year, especially compared to last year.
Right, after losing 11 in a row and then coming into the season, losing their first couple and now a couple wins, right?
Two
to be exact. So, it's good to see them turning the corner a little bit as well and getting some wins. But, I'm not here to point out any on the negative side, and I don't really want to point out any on the negative side. And I really can't think of a team on our high school board that I look at that I expected to be better than they are. If you think about it,
about to say it's almost been all close to chalk when you look at
it.
Once we've got to the sixth game, we thought Kramer, the way they started off on fire, that they're moving up in the top 10, and then now you turn around and you get stomped by Ashbrook, that turns that around, and that puts everybody back in place. For me, everything else, I mean, you look across.
It's pretty normal.
You expect the three or to four of the Cleveland County teams to occupy the top five or six spots. And then you got Lincoln and East Lincoln, and those are the ones you expect to be there.
Think of Lincoln, their coaching change this year, first year under Coach Gibson, and it's 4-1 already.
Best start in coach's history there at Lincoln and Wright, Terry.
For a first year coach, it could be. Just looking across the board, we expected Shelby to be where they are right now. We expected Crest to be. Those aren't surprises at all. And like you guys said, it's pretty much chalk. We just really haven't, in a way, you don't like that because you like to see some surprises. But I am going to give two Gaston County schools some credit because I think their teams are much improved this year, and that's East Gaston and North Gaston.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen both of those teams play. North Gaston is really strong on the defensive side of the ball and got a decent running game, and East Gaston, on the other hand, is really strong on the offensive side of the ball and getting ready to add to that.
Yes,
getting
they are.
Ready to be even better when they add Washington in that roster at the end of this coming week. He won't get to play Monday from what we understand, but probably will get to play next Friday in that matchup. So conference races, you got to think now with Shelby's win over Kings Mountain last night that SMAC conference is going to come down again to the final game of the year. I can't imagine it happening any other way.
Unless Kings Mountain gets a hold of Crest.
Right. And that's going to be the only thing that could keep it from mattering. And still that last game will, still yet that last game will play a big part in it. If Kings Mountain would happen to upset Crest, we could have a three-way tie at the end of the season. So, I don't think – I doubt you guys disagree, though, that Crest and Shelby are the favorites there heading forward with next 6 weeks. Then you look at the SD7. I think this Friday night's game is going to go a long way toward a conference championship. I would never rule out a team like Maiden. I never rule out West Caldwell, and I still wouldn't rule Newton out, because these teams can all score points. But, you know, the way the conference is going the last couple of years, you look up there in Lincoln and East Lincoln play early in the conference schedule the second week, but you got to think that one again is going to go a long way toward determining the champion. And everybody knows East Lincoln's the favorite in that game. Lincoln had to play almost perfect against East Lincoln to win that game.
Well, I think everybody's playing for third in that conference. Anyway, but that's my opinion.
I still think the Maiden-Lincoln game at the end of the year could be huge.
I mean, when you got a quarterback like that, anything can happen for Maiden.
Don't know the status of their running back, Huff, but I don't think he played.
He did not play.
He's out for 3 weeks. That's what I heard last night, yeah.
All right, Terry, Monday night, Crest, 6 o'clock. We'll go live at 5. Burns starts at 7 or 7:37, right? 7. They'll go live at 6:30. Online on KTC, you can watch both of them. Now, then next Friday night, we'll have East Rutherford at Burns, Chase at Crest, Mooresville at North Lincoln, and North Gaston at Ashbrooks as games you can watch live online. East Burke at Shelby will be watched live online and listen on WHS. And then you guys, David, will have probably our game of the week next week, East Lincoln at Lincoln on WLON. And only you can watch online as well. We should have, looking at all those places, we have good internet signal at all those places. Hopefully the weather isn't as bad, and we'll be okay for that. So
you don't know what happened last night, what really caused the video not to
be. Well, Kings Mountain, we talked about a little bit last night, as far as Kings Mountain goes, if you looked at your phone last night, you'd probably saw you had one bar. So we couldn't use the regular network. A couple weeks back, we went to Verizon Wireless. They gave us this super computer thing that's supposed to work. We went over and tested it at Kings Mountain, and it worked for a little bit while there. But once you get in there with 7,000, how many ever thousands of people you got there,
cell phones and everything,
it's raining, you know, all that other stuff goes, it's storming. Every time we went to press to shoot the video through, we would it would just crash on us basically as far as the video went. So we just went with all audio last night, so everybody could definitely listen
to
it. And in Kings Mountain, and like I said, if these press boxes would have the internet and stuff, we would never have these problems, you know, high-speed internet in the press boxes. But, I mean, it's hard to justify putting high-speed internet in a box used five, 6 days a year.
Right.
So we understand that But, yeah, so as always, we can't guarantee we'll have video at some of these places. Kings Mountain going forward. Next week, King Crest is going to be at Kings Mountain. That's going to be audio only.
They get to bulk over in a hurry, don't they?
Yeah, they get to turn right around.
Schedule makers not kind.
They might get a week off. Do they get a week off this week, Terry, or they got a game between now? Do you know off the top of your head?
I don't know.
Who's that?
Kings Mountain.
Kings Mountain.
I think it's this coming week.
All right.
I'm looking.
No. October 9th is Crest Kings Mountain. I'm saying.
Okay. I thought you were saying.
I'm wondering, do they have a bye this week coming up? But they're not on my schedule right now.
Kings Mountain isn't open until the last weekend in October.
Okay. So then they got a game next week, and then Crest. So,
So who are they facing?
They play Drone on the road next week. Okay. Kings Mountain goes to Drone, comes back home to play Crest. So.
And be scary with that, because last year Drone defeated Kings Mountain.
Yep.
All right.
Other ones in that. I want to get back to the conferences just for a minute. Thomas Jefferson, that's you guys. I mean, what do you guys think about Thomas Jefferson and that Southern Piedmont 1A with Best Mercedes, Cherrill in there, Thomas Jefferson? I mean, Thomas Jefferson is not the only undefeated team. Pine Lake Prep is still undefeated overall.
It's probably going to come down between those two.
Yeah, I'd say that. And I remember Pine Lake Prep, weren't they about – they had a good year last year as well, so they're improving. They're in that Mooresville area. Pretty much every team in the Mooresville area, you got Lake Norman, Mooresville, and now Pine Lake Prep. Usually that's a good area for football. And it's proven so right now. So I'd have to say Pine Lake Prep, I feel like, is the favorite.
North Piedmont 3A, 4A, that's the one that one of our local teams plays in, North Lincoln. Smoke will tell you the truth. They're going to struggle in that conference. That's a tough conference. They're going to have to play the likes of Lake Norman and Mooresville, South Iredale, and Statesville in that conference. And that's definitely not going to be easy. And as they go, but I don't even know who I would pick as the favorite in there unless I just go with Statesville. I mean, that's a heck of a conference.
Statesville, the problem with them is, I mean, the last two or three years they've started struggling a little bit, but as the season goes along, they get so much better. And last year made it to the third round of the playoffs. Mooresville, they don't have the same – I mean, they don't have a Keese Rankin there anymore. Lake Norman doesn't have Ledowski. It's going to be about a four-way race between those four teams you mentioned.
There's a rundown of those. We'll look at the Big South and the Northwestern 3A, 4A when we come back after this timeout. It's coming past the innocent.
We believe in what we do. We love this town. We live in just like you. We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings. I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country for a live radio remote broadcast this Saturday, September 26th at Quality Landscaping Materials. It's their gigantic grand opening event at the brand new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. You'll find landscape materials, storage buildings, and garages, plus stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more, and register to win some great prizes, too. And Big O Country will be there broadcasting live from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have free hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there for the gigantic grand opening event at Quality Landscaping Materials. Now in the new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Come check it out right across from Tractor Supply. Call 704-862-0770 for more information or visit the website at qualitylandscapematerials.com.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties. Brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WOHS, WCSL, and WLON, and by Crossroads Ford in Shelby, your hometown Ford dealer. Howards Creek Baptist Church on Highway 27 west of Lincolnton is having an old-fashioned day on October 4th. Everyone is welcome. Men, wear your overalls and boots, and women, wear your bonnets and long dresses. Bring a cover dish and there'll be lots of old-fashioned singing with the Beacons. Services beginning at 10:30 a.m. And Hospice of Cleveland County presents their Memory Bear Workshop on Thursday, October 1st at the Hospice of Cleveland County Administration Building. The workshop will be held from 9 a.m. till noon or from 4 p.m. till 7 p.m. For more information, call Hospice of Cleveland County at 704-487-4677. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper, Big O Country, WOHS 1390 AM, WCSL 1590 AM, and WLON 1050 AM, and by Crossroads Ford in Shelby. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com.
Buy here, pay here at the Essener Auto Sales in Shelby, the home of the satisfied customer. Come in now for your next vehicle at a price and payment you can afford. See their selection online at EssenerAutoSales.com and pick up this week's WhatsApp Shopper and play the Essener Auto Sale Sports Trivia Game. Win a free $10 gift certificate to the clock. Essener Auto Sales, 417 South Post Road in Shelby, right next to Bojangles, the home of the satisfied customer.
It's time. Time to head to the Pine Mountain Golf Course. Pine Mountain invites all former Pine Grove Golf Course players to come on up. You'll find a challenging 18-hole par 68 course. Play all day on weekends for only $22. Seniors can play and ride on weekends for $19. And ask about the Clip and Save coupons available. Call 828-433-4950 for your tee time at the Pine Mountain Golf Course, located at the base of the beautiful South Mountain State Park.
There you go, Ann. Your new account is now open. Just one more little thing. Here's your card. What was that?
It's my new bank. Every time I turn around, I get hit with another fee.
You need to get an account at Carolina Federal Credit Union.
She's right.
Tired of getting hit by bank fees? Switch to Carolina Federal Credit Union today. Make those pains go away.
Here's your receipt.
I spent last night in the arms of a girl in Louisiana.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. David, Terry, Jason, Kevin, Levin with you on a rainy, damp Saturday morning, and I see rain falling as we look out our studio windows here on in Cherryville, North Carolina. Before we get back into it, I'm just going to do just a real quick thing on those two conferences, and then we'll look at some baseball and football on the pro levels. But let's check in with Calvin and Perk at Quality Landscaping Materials in Gastonia.
Okay, thank you, guys. Yes, we are at Quality Landscaping Materials in Gaston. We invite you to come on out today. It's the big grand opening, Perk.
Grand opening.
Listen, there's nothing you can do today.
No.
It's raining. You can't work in the yard.
That's right.
That's right. You can't go ride motorcycles today.
No, it's good and cool. You can get your flowers. Go ahead and set them out. The rain's intermittent. Yep. Now, it's not raining at all right now. Come on out and get them. During the day, sometime take a break, go out and plant you a few flowers, make your yard look pretty. And
exactly.
Come out. They've got cookies, cakes, cupcakes.
Oh, my goodness.
They've given away T-shirts. They got some sunglasses in there. They got your cup holders.
Right.
And come out and register. We're giving away some wonderful prizes. We're going to give away some Renaissance Festival tickets, some Cleveland County Fair tickets, which starts next weekend, free rounds of golf at Crowder's Mountain Golf Course, $25 gift card to Newt's.
Newt's.
Those famous What's Up T-shirts. But it's just a beautiful day coming, and we're going to have Subway sandwiches from Bogor City here in a few moments.
You better believe it.
We've got your chips. We've got your drinks. And these people are so friendly. We walked in, and they've tried to give us everything. We told them no, we had our own.
That's right.
We come prepared.
Listen, if you're getting ready to do some landscaping around your home or business, check it out here. They've got landscape materials, buildings, stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more. And they got the different color mulch. Got the red mulch, the brown mulch, the black mulch here.
Double-beaded hardwood. No termites get in any of this stuff that they got.
Have you noticed the fireplace behind us?
I did. It's beautiful.
Is that not nice?
They've got rock for your landscaping. They've got big old blocks. They've got little rocks. They've got everything. They've got these big old – Calvin and I have had to move and get up underneath the building. They've got these sheds, and they're wonderful.
Yeah.
They've got some wood ones. They've got some metal ones. Like Calvin says, come. They'll load your mulch up for you with your big old bobcats. They'll just take care of you here.
Yeah, when you come over to see us, we are not under the Winnebago awning today. We're under one of their big buildings out
That's
here.
That's right. Just look for the red and black shirt. You'll find us.
It's easy to find, isn't it?
That's right. But look for the big old QLM in the sky, and you'll see us. Come on out and join us today.
Again, it's located at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. It's easy to find. Come on out
That's
and see
right.
us. We'll be here till 2 o'clock today. All right, back to you guys.
All right. Thank you, Calvin and Perk, and we will check in with them a little bit later on. Just real quick, the Big South, I still like South Point until somebody can conquer those guys and take that away from them. And the Northwestern 3.
Hey, Farsview's the champ.
Well, that's true.
They're the defending champs right now.
Were they co-champs, but Farsview beat them?
That's what it was.
Was it? Who beat Farsview last year? Was it Ashbrook?
Good question.
That is a good question. Because as I look at it, you got to think that's probably the only one that out of
well,
the last
Well, I know
year that
South Point's
have,
won 32 of their last 33 games, and that's the only game they lost, that overtime game.
Conference games.
Yeah, last year.
And also, I guess I would pick Freedom and South Caldwell to battle it out in the Northwestern, with Freedom maybe getting a slight edge in that one. Just
Emmons will make a lot of difference.
Yeah. He's pretty good, ain't he? He's pretty good. Pirates beat the Cubs last night, 3-2, or yesterday afternoon it might have been.
Seven straight.
Seven in a row? Seven.
For Pittsburgh.
Okay. They've been streaky. They win seven, they lose five, they win seven. Mm. White Sox beat the Yankees 5-2. The Yankees divisional champ hopes have all but been washed away. Philadelphia beat Washington 8-2. Toronto 5, Tampa Bay 3. That's why, because Toronto continues to win. Don't know if you guys caught any of the Toronto and New York Yankee series on TV this week. It was on ESPN a couple nights, and it was on maybe the MLB Network one night. That was like a playoff series, guys. I mean, that thing had all the intensity of a ALCS, and who knows, we might see those two in the ALCS. Terry says no way, but you never know. Detroit beat Minnesota 6-4. The Mets pounded the Reds 12-5. Boston beats the Orioles 7-0. Miami over Atlanta in a softball game 12-11. Texas 6, Houston 2, Cleveland over Kansas City 6-0. Has Toronto got the best record yet?
No.
We'll check that out in a second. Colorado beat the Dodgers 7-4. Milwaukee defeated the Cardinals last night 4-3. Angels over Seattle 8-4. Oakland beat the Giants 5-4. And Arizona beat the Padres 6-3. As I'm pulling up the standings, you guys fill me in on a subject that I just caught a glimpse of. What was the – was it Joe West? The umpire and Madison Bumgarner.
That was awesome.
Well, tell me about it. I don't know.
Bumgarner threw a pitch he thought was a strike.
Well, it looked about a foot outside.
Side,
it was like
a
Greg Maddox strike.
So it was a walk. And so as Bumgarner is there, turn around and staring down Joe West, and Joe West is staring him down as well. And
see who's going to flinch. 10 seconds, I think they put a clock on it.
Yeah. See who's going to flinch first. And
I just called
well,
a
well,
fi-
well, finally,
2 seconds.
Like West kind of. He kind of nodded at him, and Madison nodded back at him, and then they both put their helmets and hats on, and then Madison looked back at him and just kind of shook his head. But what's funny, did you see Jimmy Rollins?
No, I didn't.
Jimmy
I didn't
Rollins in another game, the next game night, Joe West was at third base. Rollins hit a triple. He gets to third. He calls time. And then he just stares at West, and him and West stared at each other for about 10 seconds, and Rollins didn't move, kind of making fun of Madison Bumgarner there a little bit.
I missed that. I knew there was some kind of little confrontation. But
and I think West is from Western North Carolina area.
Yeah, that's what
as well,
he said.
So
yeah. He said, you don't mess with
is
the two
he?
Boys.
Yeah. Is he?
Yeah, he's from I'll look it up.
Toronto Blue Jays lead the American League East by 4 games, 88-65. But guys, that means they've played 153, which leaves them with only nine games left and a 4-game lead. That's pretty comfortable
at this point. Asheville went to Elon.
Is he? Okay. Went to college in the central part of the state. Mm-hmm. Yankees 4 games back. Nobody else in there in playoff contention. Terry's Royals still do have the best record in the American League at 89-64 by 1 game right now over Toronto. Here's the thing, Terry, and I'm going to ask you this question. Let me give the West real quick. Texas leads the Astros by 4.5, so it looks like Texas is going to win that division. Would you rather finish with the best record and face the Yankees in the first round? In your first round, because that's probably what's going to happen. If Yankees are a wild card and they beat the Astros in a wild card game, then you got the Yankees. Would you rather face the Yankees or would you rather face Toronto?
Well, good question, because the way we've been playing, well, the way we've been playing lately is like we've been trying to lose.
Yeah.
So we can lose that, you know, lead that we got, which you said is down to 1.
Let me ask you a question for you, Terry. You know, you guys, you know, you're not used to being in the postseason. I don't know how this works. So how it works is you want the home field advantage no matter what.
No matter who you play.
Because Cardinals have lost 2 or 3 World Series because they give it to the American League because some designated hitter hit 3 home runs in an All-Star game. So always take the home field.
Right now, we've got it.
With only a week to go. You got a 1-game edge on it with only a week to go. How do they determine the tiebreaker if they finish with the same record? Is it head-to-head competition? Is it head-to-head?
On what now?
If
on
the that? Tiebreaker of 2 division winners have the same record.
I would imagine so.
Probably is head-to-head.
It's
well,
only fairway.
We'll get back to baseball in a minute. We're going to go right back to high school football here briefly because Coach Lance Ware from Shelby is up and awake now. And, Coach, the question of the day is, are you dry yet?
Barely, but I am up late night, wet night, good to get a win against a really good Kings Mountain team.
Coach, I'm sure it was. I actually got to see your team play last night in that at times a heavy mist and at times a heavy downpour last night. And you know, I thought early on in the game, and you can tell me you guys were capitalizing on Kings Mountain mistakes. You know, you got that bad snap on a punt and you recovered it in the end zone for a touchdown. You guys ran a kickoff back for a touchdown. They tried to squib kick it and keep you from doing that, but your kick returner picked it up out. Run everybody, but it seemed like in the early part of the game that the rain and the wet ball was really affecting your offense a bit.
No doubt, it was tough. You know, Barquez had some trouble with the rush and the wet, and we dropped some balls, had some overthrows. Then they were good. Their defensive line did a good mm-hmm. job getting pressure on us forward, and it'll cover us. You know, we just did not play well offensively, and the special team scores were huge, and that's a huge part of the game. You know, we taught our kids about that being, you know, one third of what the battles you got to win. So we won that, got those 2 scores. Defense, I thought, played well. Even one of the scores that we gave up, we had some bad, put them in a bad spot. You know, when Kings Mountain blocked our punt. But it was a sloppy night, but it was raining on both sides. So that's no excuse. We got to play better offensively. But Xavier Brooks and Antoine Wright were able to do some things in the running game to help us win.
That's where I was going next, Coach. We've heard all year about your passing game and how good that passing game is. But my takeaway from that game last night, you know, you're missing the camp kid in that backfield. But, man, what a running game you still had last night. And if I got the names right, Brooks and Sims, the bulk of the ball carrying last night?
Right. Xavier Brooks and everybody calls him Truck Sims.
He looks like a truck.
They've done a good job. And I've had to sell them, too, on that. You know, there's going to come a time when we have to run the ball because they've been in our offensive line, too. And they take a lot of pride in that. And they did a great job last night of executing the running game. And then also we put Antoine and Jaden in the backfield some, too.
Yeah, I thought your offensive side, you know, I thought things worked out for you guys, especially when you run the ball. It looks like you were just getting huge chunks of yardage on the ground in that game. I have not seen the final stats on it, but you guys had to be way up there in the rushing department. And then on the other side, you guys defensively did a real good job on the McClooney kid, the Kings Mountain stud in the backfield.
Yeah, defensively it starts with stopping the run, and we're able to do that, but they had some big plays in the passing game, some things on the back end that we got to get corrected. We had a lot of young kids, and you know, all that. That's kind of an excuse. They've got to play better sometimes. We got to coach them better and get them in situations so they can be successful. But Burns made some good throws, and it was a great game. I'm sure to watch too.
You guys have played one of the toughest schedules, I think, of anybody in our area, probably anybody in the state of North Carolina, with the schedule that you've had in the early going, and last night being one of your first big tests in as far as conference play goes. But you have played the likes of AC Reynolds. You've played Freedom. You got to help me with that other big team that you played in the non-conference schedule. But
South Point,
yes. Where I'm trying to go, Coach, with this is, how did Kings Mountain look to you guys athletically and speed-wise as compared to those real good non-conference opponents?
I think they were as good as anybody we've played. The quarterback made good decisions. They're like anybody else, a little banged up. They were missing a McLean kid, but McLean's a great running back. Burchett's a great receiver. They were very, very physical on defense. I thought they were right there with the AC Reynolds and the Freedom and the South Point, the 3A. I think they'll make some noise in the playoffs.
Yeah, you were mentioning the Merchant kid. I thought he was a playmaker last night for Kings Mountain. He was the big star, I think, for them last night offensively in that game. He just made plays. He really did. Coach, I noticed last night toward the end of the game, you guys sustained a couple injuries, and I don't know. I know one was the Sims kid come off limping a couple times. I even saw him limp back into the huddle one time after he left the sideline and limped back into the huddle. Looked like you kind of questioned him, like, are you sure you need to be out there? But I saw him, and to me, that's a lot of heart, a kid that wants to be out there despite the injury or the cramps or whatever's going on. And then you had another kid that went down, looked to me like on a punt, and he looked to me like he had a back injury. Is that what that was?
That's correct. He took a knee to the lower back, kind of kidney area, and we spent another night over there at the ER. But he's all right. He's going to be okay. I think a lot of spasms, nothing too serious. So hopefully, we'll get him back at some point. Yes, we are banged up. We've had our share of injuries, but that's part of the game. We've told them, next man's got to step up. We just keep looking for that next man sometimes, because we've got a lot of people over there in street clothes. Hopefully we're going to get some of those back in the next few weeks. And we're keeping our training way too busy, though.
Yeah, I noticed that, because I don't know how many times I saw you out on the field checking on a player because they lay there and didn't get up for a while. But do you think I know players can get injured at any time, and NFL games are not called off because of weather. College games are not called off because of weather, unless there's lightning involved. Do you think that that field conditions, and I'm not saying you guys shouldn't have played last night, because there was a ton of games played last night. That's not the question at all. But do you think wet fields play a part in make more injuries?
I don't think so. For instance, our injuries last night weren't.
Right.
They didn't have anything to do with the field, and I don't think Coach Lawrence did either. I think that's just part of it. I think as a player, especially being a lineman, you love a night like last night, where you could kind of slop around in the mud and have a big time. As a receiver, you probably don't like last night. But it is what it is. It's the same on both sides. That's the cards we were dealt, and we had to play.
6 weeks in the book, 6 weeks to go in the high school football season. Of course, you guys have your open week in that next 6 week span, but you got the likes of East Burke coming up this week. Then you go to East Rutherford, then Burns, then At Drone, then Crest. It's like there's not an open night in this conference, not a night off, I should say. Everybody's going to be tough the rest of the way for you guys in this conference, but You know, at the halfway point now in the regular season, how do you assess your team?
Well, I'm pleased we're 6-0, especially with who we've played.
Mm-hmm.
And very, you know, we try to keep them focused, take it one game at a time, and you know, you can't be 8-0 to 7-0. You got to win that next one. And you know, East Berks a team that I've seen on film a little bit who looks budget proof.
Right.
Ryan Newell, the kid, is a special player. I've seen them; they do a great job getting him the ball, and you know, he hurt us last year. So we'll have to. You know, this is a tough conference. You got to do a good job preparing each week, get kids ready to play, and you know. But to be 6-0 right now, we're pretty pleased with that. We just got to get healthy like everybody else.
Well, Coach, a big win last night on the road, a county rival. You guys win the Battle of Buffalo Creek. Congratulations on that 34-20 win, and keep up the good work.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Appreciate it. Coach Lance Ware there, got to be feeling good about his team's performance last night on the road in the rain. Even though they struggled on offense early in that game, they come away with a 2-touchdown win. Take another break. Back to wrap up Sports Talk in a moment.
Rates are low today. The time is right to improve your home. We have home improvement loans and we're lending right now. Join your neighbors and friends and people all over our local communities who are improving the quality of their lives by improving the quality of their homes. We're an equal housing lender. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community minded just like you.
I'm Calvin Hastings. I want to invite you to join me along with Big O Country for a live ready remote broadcast this Saturday, September 26th at Quality Landscaping Materials. It's their gigantic grand opening event at the brand new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia, right across from Tractor Supply. You'll find landscape materials, storage buildings, and garages, plus stone, pavers, gravel, mulch, and more, and register to win some great prizes too. And Big O Country will be there broadcasting live from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have free hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there for the gigantic grand opening event at Quality Landscaping Materials. Now in the new location at 3925 West Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Come check it out right across from Tractor Supply. Call 704-862-0770 for more information or visit the website at QualityLandscapeMaterials.com.
Third down and very short from the 1.5-yard line with the Panthers up 10-0. Here's Cam Newton, leaps, does the Superman thing, extends the ball. Touchdown, Carolina Panthers.
Carolina Panther in NFL football right here at Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON.
And welcome back to Sports Talk. David, Terry, Jason, Kevin, Evan. Wet, rainy Saturday morning, so glad to have you with us. We were running through the baseball scenario when we went away and asking Terry who he'd rather play, and I agree. I mean, playoffs are going to be tough. They're supposed to be tough. So, you know, either team may draw in that, whether it be Toronto or the Texas Rangers or the wild card, which might be the Yankees. I think they'll all be pretty good series. Mets lead the East in the National League comfortably, 8.5 games. They're in the playoffs. Cardinals, 3-game lead didn't seem comfortable a month ago, but now with just a week left, a 3-game lead's pretty good in that division as they lead the Pirates by 3 and the Cubs by 7.5, although the Pirates and Cubs probably going to be playing that 1-game playoff for that wild card. And then the Dodgers lead the Giants. The Giants, it's the wrong year for the Giants. Yeah. It's the odd year, so status quo, the Giants are going to be
eliminated.
They're going to be left out. Going to be left out. You guys want to talk a little bit about the we talk college football. Let's talk a little bit about the NFL and what's coming up. And Terry, honestly, I want to know, how bad did it hurt you last week when you saw your quarterback Romo go down with the injury and later to find out he was going to be out for a substantial amount of time?
Did you have T.O. tears?
No. I mean, Wheaton come in, performed very well, 7-for-7. touchdown. I mean, you know, he did what he was supposed to do. And then this week when he came in, and I even sent Jason a couple of texts. I mean, you know, maybe Washington should have got Castle, you know. But we end up getting him. I think it's a great backup. He led when Brady went down at New England. He led them to the playoffs. He did it at Kansas City, led them to the playoffs. So I think we got a great backup. So if Wheaton can't perform, I think he'd be okay. Yep. But not to be a homer, but Dallas will beat Atlanta by 10.
They may do it.
Not with that. Not with the Wheaton. Not with that. Wheaton.
Well, I'm gonna be honest with you. See, people keep forgetting since Lee's back on our defense. Our defense is
defense
way looked
pretty
better.
Good, but
way better.
I don't think anybody can stop Julio Jones the way he's been performing right now. That's gonna be that's
especially
gonna be.
With Dallas's number one corner out for the year.
Mm-hmm. But
should be an entertaining game. I mean,
playing in Dallas. Mm-hmm. Just beware.
All right,
but that's where they don't play as well.
Yeah, just beware. Yeah,
4-4 last team. Year at home.
We done gonna come out looking like my quarterback was looking like Kirk was looking, and you want to hear an interesting stat?
31-21.
That's your score. You want to hear just stat? Kirk Cousins and RG3 have thrown the same amount of interceptions, 23 in their career. RG3 has had 500 more pass attempts. You know who else threw 23 interceptions in their career and had 177 more pass attempts? Jamarcus Russell. Jamarcus Russell. Kirk Cousins is no good. Get him out.
Your best quarterback
it's
is your number two.
It's Colt McCoy. Put Robert back in the game. It can't be no worse.
It is. And then when people talk about Romo and all the interceptions he throws at wrong times, yeah, he does. But Cousins throws interceptions all the time. At least two every game.
Right time, wrong time, anytime.
Yeah. But shout out to the hottest team right now. Who would you say is the hottest team right now in the NFL?
Probably the Patriots. I have to say
that. They're really good, y'all.
I mean, Tom Brady threw for
they really are.
500 yards.
I mean, they're going to be hard to beat.
Dallas will not beat them.
And let me tell you something about the Patriots right now. In their mind, with all the things that went on them in the offseason, they're week to week, but they're also in their mind 16-0.
That's exactly
they are
right.
Thinking mm-hmm. about 16-0 because they're out to prove a point.
2007 all over again.
And Robert Kraft will love nothing more than to go to the Super Bowl podium and get that Super Bowl trophy from Roger Goodell.
Oh, Goodell won't show up. Goodell will not show up.
You know what I do? I go up on there with a deflated game ball. Go up there and present them with a deflated game. Let me tell you one team in my mind that gets overlooked a lot, but a team I think is really good. Arizona. Arizona Cardinals.
Just Bruce from Arians, where they're at.
And Bruce Arians has become, to me, one of the elite coaches
in
the
league.
I mean, he took the Colts to the playoffs when Pagano was down, and you know, here he is leading an Arizona team. Do you guys know that Carson Palmer, hadn't he won like 14 of his last 17 starts?
I think so.
Something like that.
It's just that he's been so hurt so often.
He has.
Remember.
But Bruce Arians, just to show how good of a coach he was, is his first year he missed the playoffs, but he had a 10-6 record. And he took a team that had Drew Stanton, I believe, as quarterback, and, you know, just too many quarterback injuries last year. And they made it to the playoffs. Now, given they lost in the wild card round, but they had their third string quarterback. That defense is good. Just Bruce Arians is a great coach. I will say he's a great coach.
Kevin, who's on the road now, just texted me and says in his power poll this week he had Arizona as his number one. So, and I said, I can't disagree. I mean, you know, they're going to get some stiffer tests down the road because they have beat two teams that struggled. But guess what? They pounded those teams.
Yeah. Right.
They did what you're supposed to do. They can only play who they're dealt. And they pounded New Orleans and Chicago.
Yeah.
They pounded them pretty bad. But I just think they always get overlooked. And you know what? Seattle's good. They are real good. And they're going to make noise. And they're going to win their next two because they play Detroit and Minnesota at home. So they're likely going to win those and be back in.
Chicago.
But to catch Arizona, who has a two-game lead already, may be hard. Maybe harder than people might think.
Well, there you go, because they're coming out saying he's on 0-2. 12% of teams make the playoffs.
Right.
They're 0-2. The Colts are 0-2.
Yeah, and those two surprise teams, and there's more drama going on in Indy. You know, Chuck Pagano's basically in his last year of his deal. He didn't sign it. He only got offered a 1-year extension.
Taking shots at the GM,
and so it's some drama going on in Indy.
Dallas, I mean, Terry, how many realistically? Let's say Romo misses eight weeks. Yeah. Realistically, how many would you want him to win?
Dallas only out of 8 weeks, and when he got a bye week in here too.
What would you
so
feel good
help.
About? What's the number that you would feel good about if they won?
They need to go 4-3.
4-3. You feel okay if they went 4-3?
Yeah, because they don't play Washington until the very end of the year twice late.
I agree. If they could go 4-3 in that stretch without Dez and without Romo, I think they got to be happy. Got to be happy
and
with
for
that.
Dez, I know we're about to go. For Dez, he's got the same injury that Kevin Durant had.
He does, but he keeps saying he's back when Romo comes back.
I got a feeling he won't.
One thing I want to throw two other teams out there we better not close our eyes on, and we didn't even mention Green Bay, but they're really good, and Pittsburgh. And you know, Pittsburgh's offense has been really good, and now they're going to get their best weapon back.
Mm-hmm. So, also going to be interesting to see if the Jets can continue that good start that they've had in the past 2 weeks.
Like I said, as long as it lasts, J-E-T-S, Jets. They win. Find a way to win. Thanks for tuning in to Sports Talk this morning. For Smoke Man, Evan Love, with Kevin Hastings, Terry Reinhart, Jason Barber, I'm David Kiever. See you next week.
Rest easy and sleep great.